love and energy, more than hate and jealousy. Now this is time, we need education, money, bullets and bombs. Now this is time, we need to care for the young and old, born in silver and gold. Now this is time, we have to wake up and change the world. As the result of 2,000 years of hypocrisy, ego-driven leaders in pursuit of property, power and wealth and fame, oppressing and murdering, killing all in God's name. Iniquity spread across the nation, humanity is in true separation. In the midst of our darkest hour, we rise to reclaim our power. In a this time, we need love and unity, more than hate and jealousy. Yeah. In a this time, we need education, more than bullets and bombs. We say we not give up,
not give up.
Using dirty politicians, brainwashed education, war on religion, racial division, food with no nutrition. Hey, this is the Babylon system. Their intentions to use are their wicked invention. All the propaganda promoting consumerism, exile and distraction, only misdirection to break I and I connection. But if you want comfort, me make you not say what I want. This is how I get you ready for the Armageddon. I'm in a video revolution. Power by love and compassion. Cause if we go at them with weapons, then they have more guns. Go at them with money, then they have more funds. With unification, then time's too done. We owe to our daughters and sons. In a DC time, more than hate and jealousy. In a this is time, we need education, more than bullets and bombs. In a this is time, we need to care for the young and old, more than silver and gold. In a this is time, we have to wake up and change the world. In a this is time, we need love and energy, more than hate and jealousy. In a this is time, we need education, more than bullets and bombs. In a this is time, we need to care for the young and old, more than silver and gold. In a this is time, we have to wake up and change the world.
The sharing of biased and false news has become all too common on social media. More alarming, some media outlets publish these same fake stories without checking facts first.
The sharing of biased and false news
has become all too common on social media. More alarming, some media outlets publish these same fake stories without checking facts first.
Because of you, we're in this mess. Forever you will acquiesce. All you love to be deceived. Whatever they tell you, you believe. Get a fight, get a mind. New believer, you are blind. Critical thinker, you are not. Never independent thought. But stick to your paradigm. Hypnotized with pantomime. Regurgitating all you hear. Spread your terror, spread your fear. take your poison, wear your mask. All they have to do is ask. Never questioning authority. Blindly following like sheep. Yes sir, no sir, three backs full. You television watching fool. Yeah.
Never your mind to be free. Never your eyes will ever see. Let the food of tyranny begging for your slavery. They who have removed control, the teeth of your very soul. Turn into the great receiver. Television watching news believer.
What is up, everyone? Welcome to the show. I'm so happy to be here today. I got my other brother from another mother, Shapu, with me. And also, a ceiling fan man is supposed to join us. He's just wrapping up a few things and getting his shit together so he can get on the show here with us. So hopefully it won't be too long. And also, Steve, if he gets off work early, he may join us as well. That would be great. But that would be then, just me and you, Shapu. So, what's going on with you? What's new?
What's new? Not much. All the ways the same, yeah.
Yeah, exciting times we're in right now. A lot of crazy stuff going on. A lot of text messages and emails and phone calls happening. Hey, oh, DJ, yeah. What's up? She says, hey, Jen and Shampoo.
Nice. Hi, DJ.
I got Angela Carson here. Angela sent me a really cool video. It's from a while back where that guy did that underwater exploration in the Gulf of Mexico, and he came upon an underwater lake, and he tried to put his submersible through that underwater lake, and he bounced right off of it, like as if it was like a barrier of some sort. that he could not get through. And that was really cool to see that video again. I hadn't seen it in a long time. And now that we are where we are with our research and everything, it's good to go back and look at that kind of stuff and see how that fit into everything. Ceiling fan, man was talking. I'm sorry, go ahead.
The first guy who discovered this stuff has been, but he's dead now. But something happened, you know. I won't say that was skill or something, but he had a weird debt.
Really?
Yes.
I did not know that. Yeah. But Ceiling Fan Man had made mention that, you know, he talks about the dome, how he sees it, and I tend to agree with this. Is that the dome, it goes over us, you know, in a curvature nature, and it comes down and then also goes under us as well. I don't know what this gentleman found underwater, but it seems to, you know, validate that theory, because if you look at the rocket testing they were doing, where they were testing the dome, those amateur, I don't know what you call them, but anyway, they were shooting up their own rocket.
The go fast rocket.
Yes. And it hits something up there. It's like, boop, right? So, but it doesn't actually like, and as fast as that thing going, and when it hit, whatever it hit, it should have pancaked in on itself and been crushed, but it didn't. It just kind of went, boop.
No, it's like putting your head on a pillow, you know, it goes and pushed, but.
Well, when this guy was describing how he went down in his submersible and tried to penetrate that underwater lake, he bounced off of it, like kind of like it was, and when I heard him say that, immediately, you know, all these years later, I thought of that rocket that hit the dome, and I thought how if the dome was a solid type of material, that rocket would have never just went boop, it would have went and would have been shattered and destroyed for the velocity that it was traveling at when it hit it. It's impossible for it to just stop like that. Without any damage to it or anything. Yeah. I thought that was really interesting.
Like, underwater, there it's because of this, these like underwater, like a sulfur, not volcanoes, but they're like pipes, and sulfur comes out and makes the water like a sulfuric, like a exofluoride, sulfur fluoride. And there's a lot of that stuff up high in the air too. And, you know, for me, I think it's like a big gas layer. It's so dense, this gas, that nothing can pass through. And you can see that. Do you know which gas I'm talking about? Exofluoride? Sulfur exofluoride?
Yeah, I've heard of it, yes.
If you inhale it, your voice go really deep, and you cannot see this gas, but as effect like water, and electricity doesn't work in that gas, no fire.
Wow.
Yeah, you can see it. They did the experimentation. I've got the video of it on my channel too. So
that's really interesting. A lot of people showing up. Welcome, everybody. We got 26 people here now. We got Michelle L2, Holistic Media, Awesome Austin, Three Fingers, Stacy Daisy. I said Daily. I apologize. RT's in the house. Angela Baby Carson is here. And thank you for that video, girl. I really appreciate it. I'll try to show it here as we get into some stuff. There was also a show out a while ago. I don't know, maybe like 2015 or something like that. It was called Under the Dome. Many of you probably have seen it. I definitely watched a season or two of it. But the premise to that was that there was this little town where a dome had appeared over it, and the people were trying to escape this dome, but they were trapped under it. They couldn't get out. And one of the things that they tried to do was to dig down or go down into some kind of cave system reservoir thing and try to dig out that way, and only to find out that the dome had gone all the way under the ground and around them. So they were really inside a bubble of a dome structure. And so it was interesting that they put out a show like that, and they show, you know, like an airplane flying along within the dome, because you can't see the dome. It's clear. So, and he's just flying along and he crashes into it. Kind of reminds you of one of those Admiral Byrd stories where he talks about, you know, his planes encountered something at 13,000 feet, 2,000 miles in or something like that. So that was reminiscent of that. It was actually a very interesting show, the whole thing. Of course, it's based on aliens, right? But whatever. CFM is not here yet. So a lot of strange stuff going on as of late. For some reason, hey, Sue Finelli, Captain Rankin's here. Melanie's in the house. Did you see my my pinned link, Melanie? You got to read the pinned link. What I wrote there. Leighton Farms is here. What's up? Steve Fennerin is in the house. Steve and I talked for 4 hours yesterday. 4 hours. Oh my gosh. It was a really good conversation. So I want to address some of this stuff. I'm not going to get too deep into it because I'm just going to drive my point home like I always do. A lot of people, especially big wiggers out there, are really getting triggered by the whole meltology, melted building, melted mountain thing, right? They really get their panties in a twist. As a matter of fact, I was shocked to hear how some of them just totally wig out when they hear this term. And there is one guy out there who I do not listen to. I have never listened to. As a matter of fact, straight from the door, there was just something I didn't like about this person, and he's been around for years. And his name is Nathan Oakley. Now, he's this flat earth debater guy, and I'm sure y'all know who he is, right? But he just recently had somebody on his show. To me, it sounded like, you know, kind of like a setup or something. I don't know, but they brought up meltology and shit went sideways after that. The poor guy, whoever he was, I don't even know who this guy was, who they brought on to debate with or bring up this topic with, but they did nothing but shred and tear him apart. And I told you guys April 30th on my last stream, I said, you know, we're under attack for sure. Right. I don't know what's going on with this community because everything that the Globies used to say to us flat earthers, the flat earthers, the big ones in our community seem to be turning around and saying the same thing to us. And that is shocking in itself. However, you know, there's times when we need to see things the way we should have been seeing them this whole time. And I look at this as a blessing in disguise. I'm very, very happy that all this is happening. You'll know them by their fruits, and boy, are they showing their fruits. I did just hear on Globebusters show, who Bob has been in my chats many, many times, say on his show, talking to his guest, which I think might have been Martin Liedek at the time with that particular conversation, that these people, these truthers, these flat earther truthers who think mountains are melted brick buildings. How crazy is that? That's so crazy. Again, we're being portrayed as these crazy people. The same things that the Globies said to us flat earthers way back in the day, the flat earther truthers are saying about us. It's very shocking that someone feels like they are, I can't even read that word. They're so blur. Yes, Melanie, I agree with you. Let me highlight your comment here. The thing is that... it makes me question what these people are really doing in our community to begin with. And why is it that they are these big name, big wig truthers? Okay. It's making me question a lot of things that I probably should have questioned a long time ago. Maybe I should have been a little bit more awake, but for some reason now it is really important for us to see this. And when I say see this, I mean, see this information about the melted building situation around us. Right. And to also see their fruits, because first off, we're not attacking them or their work or their channels. I have nothing bad to say about anybody. I certainly had nothing bad to say about Karen. Nope. I certainly have nothing bad to say about Bob or this other guy or anybody else who has, you know, me and Ray had an issue. He was making kind of fun of me with the melted building stuff. We got that stuffed beagle guy who was tripping out. Okay, I don't know what's wrong with these people. But it's to me, it's like, I don't know how you can't see it. But if you can't see it, that's okay. But don't sit around mocking me and my research and my friends and all the other people who do see it. Yeah. These are intelligent people, or at least I thought that they were intelligent people. If I can take the flat earth like a duck to water, I can see what's going on with the Mandela effect. No fucking problem. I clearly got the melted building thing and the mud flood thing because there's this whole thing going on with these mud flooders and the melted building stuff. People are getting too wrapped up in the terminology. Oh, well, I believe in melted buildings, but not mountains. Mountains can't be melted buildings. Do you know what a fucking mountain is? Do you know what a mountain is? You don't. And we're going to go through it tonight on what a mountain actually is. We're going to get right into it. Yeah. But
you know, Jen, that they don't believe the medical science, and they do believe like the geology that came from the same fucking bases, you know? They all put out this shit, but they go with the geology, but they don't go with the it doesn't make sense.
It doesn't make sense. No. You know, well, what suits them, suits them. You know what I mean? I'm going to use the mainstream narrative to hang the mainstream narrative. Because you know what? The mainstream narrative for his story, we've picked it apart. There's holes all over it. I could take their own words out of their own books and hang them with it. Because that's how fucked up their story is once you start picking it apart. For instance, the Royal Crown of Russia. Okay, the Imperial Royal Crown of Russia in 1787 or something like that. Queen, oh God, help me out, Shapu. What was her name?
Isabel?
Or Mary? Oh, it's been so
which
long.
One, since... the Crown of Russia?
Yes. Was it Queen Victoria?
Yeah, I think it's Mary.
I think it was Mary. I hate to be so vague on this because we did this live stream a while ago, but she commissioned this crown, this Imperial Crown of Russia in the late 1700s, and she expected it done by a certain time. These people, these two jewelers, and you can look up the Imperial Crown of Russia, who commissioned it and how long it took to make. Okay? It's their words, their story, his story, and they're saying it took 2 months to make this crown. You take a look at that fucking crown and think about it, okay? It's 17 whatever the fuck, okay? There's that. There is no power, no electricity. Take a good look at that crown. It was made in 2 months. Are you fucking kidding me? It doesn't take fucking rocket science, brain science to figure that one out. These people are lying, and they've actually left a breadcrumb of trails the whole way to show you that they're lying. It's like reading the 9/11 commission book. It's full of holes. Because it's one big lie. I mean, hopefully I don't get any, you know, I shouldn't be saying that stuff, whatever. Hey, ceiling fan, what's up?
Hey. What a mess. Hey, Shampoo. It's so good to be on a stream with you. How come my camera, everyone I always talk to, I look so much smaller than all the faces?
Yeah, we're close. Well, I can sit back.
No, that's fine. So, wow. Yeah, I what I miss. What happened? My mouse stopped working. Trying to work a computer without a mouse, I couldn't get into this.
Blame it on Sarah. She probably attacked your mouse when you weren't looking.
I like that. Yeah. No.
Well, I was starting on my tirade of you know this the attack on our community here, and really it just trying to get to the point where I want to tell people what we need to do to get past it. You know, these people think that they got all the answers. I don't know. I know I don't got all the answers. I just show evidence of what I consider to be evidence and putting the dots together. And it's not like I'm twisting anybody's arm to see what I see.
Here's the thing. We've all gone through a journey. Some of us woke up through Alex Jones. Some of us woke up through Joe Rogan. Some of us woke up through Trump and Q-tard stuff, okay? But then we moved on. And so I don't know what's happening in this community unless it was predestined because people were supposed to do these things, because it makes no sense. But here's what I take away from it. I'm moving on. I'll stay and, you know, do shows with you guys and gals and stuff, and whoever shows up, but I'm done with that whole hedonistic way of thinking. It's obvious the difference now, even though I don't want to ever identify as a group, as a Christian or whatever, but you can find the people that actually have the Holy Spirit and who doesn't. And to me, that's all it is, because you've got people that are that are fighting over things that are nonsense and strawmanning our arguments. We've never said all mountains are melted buildings. We've never said that. No one's given two shits about snake venom. No one cared about that until people started telling us we did. No one realized you were fighting, Jen, with anyone until someone kept saying you were. And the same thing with attacking Steve. Who attacks Steve? You know, and who attacks Dottie? It's nuts. So I was told a long time ago by someone that I'm not even talking right now that the Flat Earth community eats its own. And yeah, I am tardy. Thank you, Archie. I don't feel tardy, but I am tardy. And so
he was sniffing glue before the show.
Yeah, that's it. I didn't want to take a shower. It's too dangerous. So
but, it's very dangerous in the shower. Yeah. I almost died the other day.
Yeah. Well, get your helmets, everyone. So no,
don't sniff glue in the shower.
It's I don't know where it's coming from other than it's paid opposition or who knows what, because why all of a sudden are you fighting over these nonsense topics that no one seems to care about? The only thing that I have noticed is this. The people on the screen and Steve and the very few of us that actually know, A, I think we're at end times. B, you better get your shit together. And that means figure out that this is a spiritual attack. And C, stop worrying about how the freaking sky and moon and sun and the earth where you live. Look, here's the thing. I know where I live now. I don't fly through space on a ball. The shape, I don't know. There's stuff above me. There's stuff below me. It's all written. Do you know how your car works? No. People get in their car, they stick their key in, and they drive. And if it needs oil, the idiot like tells them, or they take it to the gas station. And that's it. There's some people that know, but the vast majority don't. So do you really need to figure out how the moon moves or how the sun moves or exactly what shape this place is or what's on the outside of Antarctica? Why aren't we looking in? Why aren't we looking at like the things that the Bible teaches us to figure out how to do manifestation? Because if we live in an electrical world where everything is moved by negative and positive charges, then it's that manifestation power. God talks about it. Jesus says he has the power through God. And if we figure out the faith of a mustard seed, we can move mountains. And so my point is this. It tells you how to figure this stuff out unless you're running from it and you're hiding from it. And what are we hearing? The same people that are telling us that we're crazy because we want to look at these buildings that look like they've been melted, which is pretty freaking obvious they have. They also tell us there's no snake in the garden. Well, that's exactly what the devil would want you to say, right? That he doesn't exist. Watch Bill Cooper. The greatest trick of the devil is to prove that he never existed. So, of course, that's why you're going to say there was no snake. What the fuck was what was making the hissing sound if there was no snake? Why does God talk about serpents constantly? And why does he say that we will have the power to tread on what? Scorpions and serpents. I mean, don't tell me that there's no snake in the Bible. You obviously haven't read your Bible. Yeah, you can read a Bible and you can break down the words. Big freaking deal. You're not getting the message. And that's why God says that he talks in parables, because those with eyes to see and ears to hear, they'll get the message. And the rest of them will take the book and they'll throw it on the shelf. And then they'll just start crapping on everyone else that because they don't understand why they're stuck on flat freaking earth. I get it. What else do we need to know about that? How many times do you have to prove to me NASA lies? I'm on board. But if that's all you do, and you never talk about the existence of God or how to save yourself, because we can only save ourselves. We can't save anyone else. We can just show them the information. And if you talk about anything other than that, obviously you're a gatekeeper. And that's my point.
Totally agree.
So, yeah, I'm done with that. I didn't turn this camera on to make a lot of money. Obviously, those are the people that are making money. We don't make shit. Because this was about turning this message on to let people know there's stuff happening. And in addition to that, thanks, DJ, in addition to that, what do we lose? Our family, our friends, people call us retarded, even in our own freaking community, and they expect you to spend $155 to go to their event? No, thank you.
Oh, no, they don't want you there. You're an undesirable.
Oh, absolutely.
We'll be across the street at the park where Free Meltology meetup. That's where we'll be.
I've been to 3 meetups that Dottie's put on free, and they were wonderful. 50-some people or better, and they were potlucks, and we had a good old time. What's wrong with that? Why do I have to spend all this money to do something that should be free? Now, you want to throw an event, and you want to have a big thing and speakers and all that, fine. Then you know what? You're entitled to make some money. But good Lord, how much? Can we figure that out? It's pretty easy. It's a lot of freaking money. I'd have festivals every freaking month if I could make that kind of money. No, I have to bust my ass and work on this farm and try to work through my savings and try to come up with ways to make money. I don't have a ton of money. I'm not raking it in on these freaking channels, but we know who is. And they make sure that they send you free shit with their advertisements on it. Whatever. Anyways.
So what we're going to do here is I'm going to have Shapu bring up the clip of this little interview with this supposed person talking about Meltology and this Nathan Oakley guy. Just to listen a little. I'm not even going to listen to the whole thing. We're just going to listen to a few minutes of it. But just to give people an example of what's going on and how we move past and above. Because I do not, first off, don't ever ask me to debate any of this crap because I don't have to. I've done thousands of hours of research and live streams on this topic. And 2.5 years into this, and there's people that are more years into it than I am who've done the research. I don't got to debate this with anybody. I know what's out there as far as what is good enough for me that God has shown me to see in this time, because I think it's really important that we're seeing this stuff because we need to be reminded where we came from, what happened, and what could possibly happen in the future, and where we need to be spiritually when this shit comes down the pike at us, because they want us trapped in fear.
And that's the other thing. Like you said, we're not saying this is it. We know everything. We're telling you we know nothing, but these are the things that we're figuring out, and what do you think? But we're scripturally, all this stuff keeps getting proven. And it's interesting to me that people want to dismiss the Bible. Okay, fine, dismiss it. But you know what? I got my saving, or whatever you want to call it, my born again, without that book. What did I do? I asked for Jesus if he's real, and he comes to you. That's it. That's all you have to do. It's nothing crazy. Everyone can do it. But it's obvious people that don't have any kind of feeling that way. They think that they're going to create this. They become gods, right? It's like they understand that they have the power of manifestation, but they forget that you have to do it in a righteous position through God. And if you just become your own God, well, that's Satanism. I don't care what you call it. You can call it New Age. You can call it whatever you want. But you don't have to read that book. But you know what? There's a lot of good information in it. And that's what figured out a lot of this out for me. They don't read it. All they do is just crap on it, just like they do with the buildings. It's so obvious you can see buildings that have been melted. What caused that? We're not sure yet. It was either the original flood or something in between. But to think that we're in this cycle that you're just going to keep coming back, well, you know what? First of all, sorry, Jen, I'm on a roll.
No, you're fired fine. Me up.
So
you're fine. Keep going.
I know of personally, and I've talked to other people that have cast out evil spirits or bad situations in the name of Jesus Christ. So say whatever you want. Say you can't say that name. Say you have to say Yeshua. Say yeah. I don't care. But that name matters to the other side. Devils and demons and whatever, they obviously believe in it. And they're trying to do the quote book of Revelations or whatever you want to call it. On the other side, they're obviously going towards this agenda. And how the rest of the world can't see this isn't a biblical event, for those of us that never even read the Bible once, no one in alive today has ever experienced anything close to this.
Don't walk anywhere.
So then my point is this, maybe we're wrong, but if I'm right, and there's only one way out of this place, and it's through Jesus, well, then that's what I'm going to work on. And how am I going to do that? I'm going to get as righteous as possible and do his teachings. And if I'm wrong, so what? I'm a better person. But you sure you want to hang your hat on that, where you think that we're completely crazy and you're going to become gods? And then you're going to like what? Masturbate to Cameron Diaz and cryptocurrency is going to save you? You can't even freaking spend cryptocurrency. I dare you to try. If you have $1 million, you get in crypto because you hit the lottery. What are you going to do? Buy a Tesla? That's it. You can't go to Home Depot and buy a wheelbarrow. So no, you got to convert that. This like the I like Rockfin because I can say things you can't, and I've actually made some money there, not like YouTube. But they pay you in a token you can't spend anywhere. So you got to take that token and you got to convert it to this token. And then you got to take that token and got to convert it to this bank. And meanwhile, it costs you somewhere around 25, 30% to do that. And if you don't have internet or power, then you ain't got no money. So what's going to save you? Jesus. That's what I see. I don't see any other answers. And if you guys want to attack melted buildings and the Bible and Jesus, give me another option, because I don't see you guys getting out of here. And if you think you're going to recycle through, what if you're wrong? That's all I'm saying. Hey, if it's a Buddhist thing, we all recycle. Big deal. Who cares? But if you're wrong, well, no bueno.
Do you really want to cycle back here after all this crap?
And God, where it's no.
Do you really want to fucking come back here?
No,
I mean, that's what I'm saying. I'm out of here. I'll be like, shoot, thank God that's done. Oh, my gosh.
And these are my thoughts. If you don't like that, okay, whatever. To do live streams and scream at people because they have different ideas, that's what Globe people did to us. Like, what is happening? The Flat Earth community became the Globe people attacking us. Fine, I'll step away from it. I wasn't really invited to much of it anyways. That's fine. Yeah. So I'm no longer in that flat earth. Ooh.
Oh, you're not in the clique. You're not in the clique. You're an undesirable because you're hanging out with me, the crazy glue sniffing retarded person who's too stupid to take a shower without killing herself. Oh, my gosh.
Fantastic.
Yeah. So, all right, Shapu, you got that clip ready?
Yeah, do you have a specific time?
That you I think it starts off right in the beginning, doesn't it?
Yeah, the beginning, the first minute.
First couple minutes there. I just want to...
I didn't listen to the rest.
Because it's hard to listen to. It's just like, you know, the vitriol that's coming out of these people, the triggering point, right? When as soon as they hear the word meltology or anything about melted buildings, they start going crazy. They just lose it, you know? It's
unless it's on purpose, you know what I mean?
I was shocked to hear this, but it also sounded staged as well. It really did.
It's like what you and Shapu and Steve said the first time that we all got attacked on this. You're like, I've been doing this for how many years? Why are you bringing it up now unless there's an agenda? And at the same time, we're told there's no snake in the garden. Oh, and there's hollow earth. No one's even discussed that. Well, if you're telling me not to look at anything, I'll look into it. And you know what I think? I think that it says it's written in the scriptures. You know what's below our feet? It's in the water. Dead things come out of the water and the inhabitants thereof. But what's God talking about if there isn't anybody down there? So anything they tell us not to look at, that's where we should be looking. Keep looking, figuring out the earth and the sky and the moon, because you'll never figure it out. God says so. But let's keep doing that. Yeah. Let's not try to figure out why we're here or how we get out of here. Let's just keep discussing. This is just a pie plate or a concave dish.
And also recognize the evidence that's around us from the last destruction that took place, whether it's cyclical or one major event. Either way, this is God's creation and he has control over these cyclical events or the one event that took place. So if you say, well, a pole shift happened or an X factor event happened, clearly there's some kind of higher power behind that said X factor event, which could only be the creator of this system that we're in. I mean, how else could it go down, right? I mean, if there's a creator to this, and also I'd like to point out God created Adam from the earth, from the clay of the earth. What are bricks made of? The clay of the earth. Who made all these bricks? Where did all the bricks come from? Where's ground level? Tell me that, okay? I'm just saying, shit's starting to add up when you really start to look at it. And we're going to listen to this real quick. So, Shapu, I don't know, on your end, you might have to mute out just to play a little bit of this, so don't echo.
Yeah. Yeah, I forgot.
All right, guys, here we go.
The rock actually keeps going and it turns into the building.
Hold on.
It talks about a flood in the Bible, doesn't it? Are you going to tell me
so,
I'm crazy?
So the seas are the blood of the people that died?
Deserts are pulverized.
Hold on. Everyone quiet. Stop. It's not audible. Yeah. Everybody talks to everybody. Right. Look, I think he's got a fair point, El Barique, because it's totally unreasonable to suggest that the seas are the tears of dying people. I mean, that's farcical. Look, just let him get on with explaining how buildings turned into rocks. Don't be unreasonable with this nonsense. Give me evidence that this rock used to be a building.
You're afraid. You won't let me talk.
Yeah, I'm terrified. Oh, no. If only I could protect myself from the truth of the melted buildings, I'd have a fulfilled life. If only the yogic people had spoken to me like they spoke to you.
If you see a bunch of the pictures that we have, you'll start seeing that this is everywhere. There's half melted.
Okay, next picture. Giant cock in rock. You telling me that this is a giant's penis?
All right, scroll up just a little. There you go.
It hurts my ears to listen to this.
I know. But I want these people, I want everybody to hear these people make fools of themselves, trying to make fools of us.
So that's all I wanted to say. Now, if you want to challenge me on the mountains, look at the pictures and tell me what you think about them.
That's fine.
You just talked 78 speed final record, and you didn't explain one thing.
I put those pictures in Master
B. They're up now. Thank you. If anyone wants to check them out, they're in Master B, as Chocolate says. So feel free to glance your eyes over the melted buildings pictures. They're up on screen for the audience now.
Thanks for listening. That's all I wanted to say. I don't want to argue. I just want to share something. That's all. Do what you want with it.
You don't provide any evidence. You don't provide any evidence. It's just you went to a class, you forgot everything you learned, and now you're just rambling.
Hey, took us through these pictures. So I've got one that looks like an internal arch in what may be a church or a temple of some kind, and then above it there's an arch in a rock formation. Okay.
So, and there's thousands of them. I mean, there's an unlimited supply of evidence on this.
What's it evidencing?
Well, those formations, what they used to be, were articulated structures. They looked like rocks, and they're the remains of something that was very advanced and beautiful at one point. And the whole plain was covered with buildings like this. That's what they're hiding.
Okay. On its face, though, you appreciate that what you've just done is made a baseless assertion and drawn a correlation with two images. Is there any evidence to suggest that the top image, which is a rock, you said it looks like a rock? No, it is a rock.
I posted like 10 images. How many are you looking at? Two? I posted like 10.
Okay, my question wasn't in regards to the quantity of images that you sent. I'll try again. You've made a baseless assertion that the rock in one of the images, in an arch shape, above a different picture of what looks like a temple with an arch, man-made, most certainly.
I haven't finished my statement.
Now, is this going to be a response about how many pictures you've sent? I haven't finished. You didn't answer me. You told me about how many pictures you'd sent, so you didn't listen. Now you're interrupting me. Thank you.
Oh my God. It's so relevant to what you're saying. What I'm saying is that
you're being asked by 10th for what evidence you have for your now baseless assertion that this rock, not looks like a rock, is a rock with an arch in it, was a building previously. Right. What evidence do you have beyond your baseless assertion that this rock was a building? Go.
Are you finished? Okay, great. That's one example.
Pause it there for real quick.
Or just turn it off.
Turn it off. I don't even know. Look, this guy's supposed to be some debater. I don't even know who this guy is that he has on or why he chose this particular person or how he even got on the show to represent this topic and talk about it. But it seemed like they picked the weakest person to come on and debate and then just railroad them and ride right over them and make a fool out of them is what it seems like. It's not surprising. I knew all these attacks were coming and there's going to be many, many more attacks on the horizon. What I'm saying is we're going to zoom right past all these jackwagons because that's exactly what they are. We see them, we know where they're at, we know who they are, what they're all about now, and we can get right around them and keep going on that path of truth like we have been doing, because that's where I feel like the Creator is leading us. He's showing us their fruits, we're seeing it, and now we know what they're all about and what we're dealing with, and we can get right around that and keep going. So I look at all this as a blessing in disguise. These people are nothing but jackwagons, and I'm being polite there. Okay, I'm not trying to be mean. I'm just saying they have jackwagon mentality, because they're using the same mentality that the Globers used on us flat earthers. And now they're like, oh, you believe these crazy flat earthers think that mountains are melted brick buildings. Well, I got to say, guys, all the ones that I've shown are, and I've been to a few spots already, boots on the ground, and I know plenty of other people who've been to boots on the ground stuff, that is finding all kinds of evidences that these are actually buildings. And we have a ton of stuff to show you tonight. One of the things I'm going to, go ahead.
All I was going to say is because some people are questioning, you know, why are we fighting? Okay, let me break that down. The people on the screen aren't fighting. The people on the screen continually are being attacked by the other people that you guys look up to and you guys call legends, which God says don't have any idols. We got rid of our idols from TV and movies and we turned them into flat earthers. And guess what? We don't know anything. None of us do. That's the beauty of this. No one will ever be able to go to Antarctica or go up into space and see if there's a dome. We'll never be able to do that. And if you give a bunch of people money to think that they're going to do it, you are retarded. So we won't ever figure this out. All we can do is just use our best discernment. So the people on the screen right now are the people that are being attacked for their beliefs that we can't prove, nor can the people that are attacking us. What you're witnessing now is people standing up for themselves and saying, we're not going to take it anymore. And I'm reading this in Timothy, 2 Timothy 3. You know what it says? It says in the last days, men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, without natural affection, truce breakers, false accusers, incompetent, fierce, despisers of those that are good, traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasures more than lovers of God. And God tells you what to do with those people because he says they have a form of godliness, but they deny the power thereof. In other words, they start figuring out, hey, maybe we can manifest and smack little ringy dingy things and look at crystals and tarot cards and think we can, you can use other divination powers and deal with demons and evil spirits. But God specifically says that if you have this form of godliness, but you deny the power, what are we supposed to do as believers? From such, turn away. So I'm just doing what I'm being told by God. I can't take it anymore. You guys want to eat each own and pretend that God doesn't exist and just debate flat earth and bitch about it and go do hedonism events. Go for it. God tells me to turn away. And that's what I'm doing. So I'm not fighting. I'm walking away and I'm praying for them. Are you kidding me? That's what we're supposed to do. Exactly. They figure this out. But I'm just worried about the people that they're taking with them. They're being deceived, because that's what he also says, that you know, God says in this time, wisdom has left us. Well, I think we can all agree with that statement. But do you know where he says it lives? Because I figured out where it is. This is something I can't say I know. Job 28:27, and unto man he said, behold, the fear of the Lord, that's wisdom, and to depart from evil is understanding. So there, that's my rant.
And to have fear of the Lord and wisdom is to also see this stuff and recognize it for what it is. Because when you see what happened to the inhabitants prior to this X Factor event, you know, what happened to them and their buildings and stuff does put the fear of God in you.
And you, that's why you said, you showed it, the Quran said, that's why he left a third so we could see what happened, but we're ignoring it because the devil does three things. He either tries to scare you that he's so powerful, so he uses fear as a weapon. He tries to pretend he doesn't exist, like the snake that didn't live in the garden. That's another weapon. Mm-hmm. And if those two don't work, he works off your ignorance. And so if you keep your sheep completely ignorant that there's a spiritual battle going on, then you're screwed. So that's what...
And if you don't know your enemy, you have no business even being on that spiritual battlefield. And that's right where they want you. They want you on the sidelines, sidetracked and distracted and living in fear and never even knowing that there's a battle going on. And you do not engage your free will. Mm. Okay. So what is a mountain? Okay. And people always say to me, oh, how can you say that these mountains, right, these extremely large, high elevation mountains were actually buildings? How far-fetched is that? Why would you even consider something like that? It's not feasible, right? Well, the inhabitants of the old world seem to have been a lot larger than us. So that means their buildings had to have been a lot larger than us, than, you know, our current buildings. We see the old world buildings now with 35, 40 foot high ceilings and doorways and stuff like that. Does not make sense to have these buildings built the way they are. We don't even build that way today, and we're average height. Same as the people back then, you would think, that built these supposed buildings of average height were building extraordinarily high ceilings, doorways, and all this stuff. Clearly, it was made for larger people, especially when we look like ants when we're inside these buildings. Like, look at Grand Central Station or 30th Street Station in Philadelphia. I mean, when you see people in there, they're tiny little things in this massive building that's supposed to be just a train station.
It's right, actually Grand Central Terminal. That was Mandela effect.
So what is the simple definition of a mountain? Okay, so it says here, a mountain. Landform that rises prominently above its surroundings, generally exhibiting steep slopes, a relatively confined summit area, and considerable local relief. Mountains generally are understood to be larger than hills, but the term has no standardized geological meaning. That's right. I'll read it again. The term has no standardized geological meaning. You know why? Because a mountain is a description of something. It doesn't say what the thing is. So the fact that everybody's freaking out about mountains being melted buildings, those people have no idea what an actual mountain really is.
They didn't even look it up in the dictionary.
So check this out. Let's go over here. The definition of mountain. Okay, the first one, an elevation of land, considerable dimensions, rising more or less abruptly, forming a conspicuous figure in the landscape, usually having a small content of surface at its summit. And then it goes in as an example. Everest is the highest mountain in the world, right? Now, here's number two definition for mountain. Something very large in size or quantity, a huge amount. A great heap. Now keep this in mind, this great heap thing right here, okay? Because we're going to go over here and look at this. First off, we're going to go to Deuteronomy 128, King James Version. Wherever shall we go up, our brethren have discouraged our hearts, saying, the people is greater and taller than we, and the cities are great and walled to the heavens. And moreover, we have seen the sons of Anakim there. So I'm going to read that part again. The people is great and taller than we, and the cities are great and walled to the heavens. This is to give you an idea of the heights of these buildings and these structures. They were walled to the heavens. Let's go to the next one. Deuteronomy 128. This is the New International Version. It's the same one, but they just use a different word here. The people are stronger and taller than we are, and the cities are large, with walls up to the sky. Okay, where are these mountains at? They're large and up into the sky. They're so massive, right? Because people can't wrap their heads around, oh, come on. Why can't a mountain just be a mountain? Why can't it just be this beautiful landscape? Well, what is a mountain? Okay, well, we look back over here. A mountain is a large heap, a great heap, a huge amount of something, very large in size or quantity.
I like number five.
Oh, I'm sorry.
She didn't see.
A woman's large breast. That as well.
Sorry, the 13-year-old boy in me immediately sees that. You put breast on a chart, I'm going to immediately, right? You saw it too, Shapu. You're just too nice to say. Yeah.
Okay, I have to go back to this other one I want to read here. Hold on. I got to find it first. Hold on. Let me read it to you from here, because I think I don't have it in these pictures. So I'll have to just grab it out of my screenshots here and read it to you, because it talks about heap. I hate when I'm dropping the ball on something when I'm on a roll.
And Queen of Swords is late. You feel tardy, you are. But you know what? You'll have to rewind the beginning, because there was some heat at the beginning.
Okay. So hold on. Wait a minute. Where was it here? Okay, maybe I don't have that one picture up here. Okay, so we're gonna go over here and I'm gonna talk to you. Let me cancel this out here. It says,
I'd like to show you the newest updates. You don't want that?
No, I'm all good. I wish it would go away. It says, when does a hill become a mountain according to the dictionary? Okay. Now, look at this landscape that they're showing you here. I find it very interesting. Okay. It says, consult the American English Merriam-Webster Dictionary, and it will tell you that a mountain is a landmass that projects conspicuously above its surroundings and is higher than a hill.
I want to address something because the cow, or sorry, I call RT the cow in the chat. He's saying, you know, okay, so like Matterhorn, right? Okay, so some of these maybe are grown crystals, mountains, I don't know. But what I'm thinking we're at now is all these big monstrous buildings that we see are just the tops. And everything else is down below us to a depth that we don't understand. Because I think one of two things happened. Obviously, an X factor occurred. But if it was, you say, the original flood, so if you've got a dome above you, right, and God says heaven's above, and then you've got the place we live on, and then shale and hell and all that's supposed to be down below, so then you'd have the firmament all the way around, so there's your ball. And then let's say if the waters above and below come in at once during the flood, that's going to cause such intense pressure and heat to make them boil, probably. I mean, again, we're talking about events we don't understand, like we've never seen. And God even says, you've never seen it, you'll never see it again. So if that happened at such a force, and then things melted, but then it cooled, and I believe the rest of the water receded, and that's what we still see there, I think the mountains go down below, and that's where the troglodytes and the slea stacks and whatever else is down there. Again, it says so. Dead things are formed under the waters and the inhabitants thereof. Why is he talking about things that live down there if they're not there? So rather than thinking that these buildings towered to the sky, which they did, some of them are just all underneath us, under the water, under the ground. Isn't there a whole water? Absolutely. Under the desert of the Sahara, there's a whole other ecosystem. So we don't understand how this stuff works.
Absolutely. I agree 100%. And when they're talking about mountains, okay, a mountain is a large heap of something, okay? And these mountains are large heaps of melted buildings. They call it a mountain, like, but they're using it in such a way so you see it a certain way, okay? So a mountain's definition, geology has only been taught since the mid to late 1800s, which is where you get the first definition right here. They put it first because this is what they want you to see first, an elevation of land, considerable dimensions rising more or less abruptly, forming a conspicuous figure in the landscape, okay? But really, it's actually just something very large in size or quantity, a huge amount, a great heap. And it talks about in the Bible how God destroyed these cities and made them these cities a great heap.
Yep.
Let me go back over here. So in this paragraph here, I find it interesting because they're talking about, it says, a mountain must first project, conspicuously, and then it must also be greater elevation than a hill. So we're trying to figure out what's the difference between a hill and a mountain, because nobody really seems to define it very well. And it says here, however kindly the folks at Merriam-Webster have neglected to define how high a hill can be before it becomes a mountain. Okay? They state that a hill is usually a round elevation of land lower than a mountain. So as you can see, we are rather like a cat chasing its own tail, still very much in a gray area.
Yeah, but so see, they should have talked to the Flat Earth community because they know better. They would have explained it to them. See, these people don't even know.
Okay, so if you go by geology, they say that push up land masses to create these mountains, these huge heaps of things, okay? And they'll tell you that these mountains are still growing. Oh, Everest grows 2 inches every year, does it? I don't know if it does. I'm just going by what they say. Is the dome getting lower or is this thing getting higher? I really don't know. All I know is that there isn't any new mountains. So where did all these mountains come from? Where's all the new mountains? Why isn't there any new mountains around?
Yeah, right.
I'm just saying.
Well, it's like evolution. You can't see mountains being grown in front of us. I mean, you can do it in your house. You can make those little magic crystal things. Those are cool.
Yeah. I'm trying to get my fingers out here. Yeah, those crystal things are really cool.
Yeah. And I think it's Dread, Musicians for Truth. So you've been around since I started doing this, and he's the reason I started turning my camera around, because he said I'd never show my face. And so I do. And all I can say is I respect his opinion for not respecting or not agreeing with us. He's been there forever. He doesn't agree, but he doesn't do streams and just shit on our ideas or make a song about
exactly.
it.
Exactly.
And so all I can say to you is I think we found the correct path. And as your friend on YouTube that I've been with you for a long time, at least look into what I'm having to say and just take a moment to think maybe the people that are telling you that the Bible was written by King James and not to look at it, maybe they're trying to keep you from looking at it for a reason. And that's all I can say about that, because I didn't start my spiritual path by reading the Bible. God told me that's something I should do. So I did it after I had already made my connection. So anyways, much love.
I love you too. All right, Chipu, I need you to bring up in our messages, all the pictures that you sent me, which are all the melted building stuff and mountains and everything. And before that, I sent you a few pictures as well. So we're going to bring up all that, if you can do that for me.
And Melanie's mad that Musicians for Truth made me show my face. I got my eye on you, 33. She says, I guess I have a face for radio.
Oh, that's not right. Oh, I think that requires a hit off the bowl. Okay. We're going to get into some cool pictures here. Also, I'm going to actually send you a couple of more pictures, Shapu, because I wanted you to see these pipes. I had Steve Fennerin was asking me about the pipes in caves, like the plumbing still working in these buildings and stuff. And here somebody had found an ancient pipe embedded in a cave wall. And I want to show this too, because they're like, who the hell put this pipe here in this cave, this ancient pipe in this cave? But it's part of the melted building. And in a lot of these caves, the plumbing's still working in these mountains, these heaps of things, these large amounts of rubble and stuff. Also, what reminds me of a mountain that would be considered a heap or a large pile would be Mount Entero, where it's nothing but just broken boulders on top, you know, it's just like talons and stuff of everything. It's not huge, big boulders. Everything's all broke up and everything. It's like a giant heap of something that was something else at one time. All right. So I'm going to show this ancient pipe work here in honor of Steve Fennerin.
You know, I can't zoom in. Oh, I'm sorry. Wrong button, man.
Okay. Let me see if I can get it up then. It's okay. If I could just get this one thing to close for me, I'll be okay. Let me show you guys this real quick. Deborah the Red Brick Chick finally received in Australia, New South Wales, Australia. It took like 2 months to get to her. But she finally got her shirt, and I'm going to show it right now because I'm so excited for her to have it. She took a picture of it for me. We go. Can you guys see this?
I see a circle spinning around.
Oh, of course.
Is that what you see, Shapu?
Yeah.
There we go. Someone's pointing to their mountains.
To their mountains, exactly. I knew you were a ceiling fan. Yes.
Is that why you make everyone point to their mountains?
Deb, if you're watching, here you are. The shirt looks really good on you, Meltology 101. And I sent her this nice little necklace here to go with it because she's super sweet. She sent me one of her shirts, which is Red Brick Chick Meltology on it. So this is, looks really, really good on you. I hope you like it. I hope you like the material. And yeah, that was really awesome that she sent me that. Yeah, so let me try to close this back out. I don't know why, but StreamYard and Facebook, they just don't play nice together for me. All right, there we go. Let me try to close this and get Shapu up here. Got the Wheel of Death. Dun, 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 dun. I'm trying to close out a couple of my links here. Maybe it'll help things work a little quicker. This is why I always try to get somebody else to share my stuff because I have to deal with this crap on my end. Oh, ceiling fan, did you get the picture I sent you of the Moai's cousins?
Yes. Yes, I did.
The Moai have cousins, guys. And we have pictures of them. 33's on the screen. Hold on.
Yeah. That's why she wants it, because then no one can see my face. Yeah, I hope you're right on that. It's just if you're not MFT, let's at least research the other side just to see. As the Jews say, couldn't wait. So, and I am Jewish.
Condemnation without investigation is the height of ignorance. These people clearly don't consider themselves ignorant on these topics and stuff, but they're going to condemn this topic and immediately bash it right out the gate. Exactly what the Globies did to all you freaking flat earthers out there. Hello.
I can't believe it. It's like we're revisiting it whenever we said anything about flat earth or whatever, and we get attacked. So now our own community, but I was told that this would happen, and sure should it did. I didn't believe him.
Yep.
I believed in all the legends. Well, there are no legends. There are no experts.
All right. So is this comment off the screen? Because it doesn't look like it's off the screen on my end. It just keeps staying.
It is. Singe Man, you're pretty funny too.
Okay,
I get it. Everyone's giving me shit. It's my friend.
All right, so I got this up now. Let me get this going here.
You ready, Shapu? I'm coming. Okay, good. I'm just reading.
He cannot be tardy.
No, I was today. Yeah.
Okay, so here it says, who built these ancient metal pipes deep inside a cave, a mountain cave? It's in a mountain cave. And then this is the picture of it here. So let me zoom in. This is an ancient pipe embedded into the wall of a melted building, guys. How many times have we told you that the plumbing still works in a lot of these buildings? Well, plumbing's come with pipes. And there's your pipes.
You sure that's not a crystal that grew around that pipe?
My mom just laughed when she heard you say that. I do not know. I don't think so. Could be. Anyway,
see, your mom has an open mind and the flat earth community doesn't. Isn't that something?
You're right, exactly. So look, is this a mountain or is this a melted building? Okay, we're kind of like in between two worlds here. A little bit more melted, it could be considered a hill, you know, or something. But clearly this was some type of structure. If you want to buy the lie of the historical narrative, which we've already figured out many, many times over, that the historical narrative, the archaeological narrative, and the geological narratives have added hundreds of thousands of years and even millions of years onto their timelines, and they're lying to us about what these structures actually are. Nobody carved this.
No, not with copper chisel and a rock, for sure.
Exactly. That's a really good picture. I like that one. All right, so let me go to this next one here. Okay, Shapu, where are we at here? Do you know what, anything about this picture? Because this is really interesting.
Egypt. This is in Egypt.
All right, we're in Egypt now, guys. Now, if you just come upon this thing and you're walking around, you might think, yo, you're just on some kind of hill here or something, right? Or some kind of outcropping of something. But look, look, it's brick. There it is. It's all brick. Okay. I'm not making it up. I'm sorry if it gets your panties in a twist, but there it fucking is. So up top here, you're just walking around on dirt. But down here, it's brick. So you fucking decide, okay? I'm just saying. All right, let's move on. All right, here we go. Is this a hill? Is this a mountain? Is this a building? I mean, what are we looking at here? I mean, OMG, guys. This looks like Herodium or something, okay? Oh, nothing to see here. This is just part of the landscape. And we call these mountains or hills, very large hills. Oh, but wait, we had some clever people that climbed up in here a long, long time ago in a galaxy far, far away and started chiseling this sucker out. That's what happened. Again, the mountain or the heap of large stuff right here was a mount. This is a mountain of melted building right here. It's a large melted building.
They're going to need bigger panties because you're going to be twisting them quite a bit if all these pictures look like this. Because
Oh, yeah. And you could see, you could see remnants of windows and doorways here, just like you see over on this side here. Now, I'm sure they probably went in and maybe cleared out some of the stuff and maybe use some of it for tourism now, clean it up a little and stuff like that. But this whole structure was something else prior to the X Factor event. It did not look like this prior to the X Factor event, prior to the mudflood event.
And it almost
event.
Looks like it was like the pyramid or pagoda shape that we see in all those buildings too, you know?
Yes. It looks very Vesuvius looking as well, very volcano-ish looking, very Herodium looking, which Herodium is admittedly a man-made building from head to toe and not just some hilltop fortress.
Yeah, it's still in Egypt.
And then you have all this in the background here too as well, coming down here. All right, then we'll go to the next picture. Okay, well, we got all this in the background here, which would be considered mountains or very, very large hills, because there's this gray area that nobody quite knows what to call these things. And, you know, there's that. So let's zoom in on these suckers over here. Okay, these are, oh, I don't know why that download thing just popped in my face. That was rude. But to me, these look like these could be domes that have melted down or pyramidal looking structures of some sort. Here, they would call these mounds now or large hills or very low mountain ranges along here. Again, a mountain is just a large heap of something. And I'm telling you that what you're looking at here is a large heap of melted building. Okay. Right there. There's a large heap of it.
No, those are crystals.
No, this is a diamond mine. That's actually what it is. It's a diamond, right, Shapu? Don't it look like that diamond mine?
Yeah, it looks exactly like the diamond mine. Yeah.
Yeah. It's a diamond mine.
It's so funny.
All right, so let's move on. Again, here.
That's why it seems like it's an organized attack, because it's so obvious. Just look at it. It doesn't take much to look at these.
It's really easy to see it once you see it, and you can't unsee it. And they're, you know, and now they're even discrediting John Levy. You know why? John Levy's been talking about melted stuff. He even talked about the Vesuvius stuff and mentioned other people's work as well. So they're attacking him, which in turn would attack me as well, because he promoted my stuff. This is a coordinated attack that is taking place. There's a reason why. And, you know, the attack is coming from within our community, guys. We're not getting attacked outside the community. No, there's nobody from Channel 10 News attacking me. There's no geologists that have come in and attacked me or any of us on this topic. It's our own people that are doing this, okay? And it's very eye-opening, but it's a blessing in disguise as well, I have to say.
I never heard about this guy, John MK Ultraviolet or something, and all of 2 years in the group, never heard this.
And this
name.
Is the guy who was on the show with him. Is that the name of the guy who was on the show?
Yeah, yeah.
I'm like, where did they get this jack wagon? I've never even heard him talk before. Who is he? Why would they pick him? Not saying that I want to get picked or anything. I'm not into debating these jack wagons. I got better things to do at my time, and I've already proven to myself and most people here listening tonight what these things actually are. So I don't need to debate anybody. But that sounded like such a setup. Why would they pick somebody like that? How did that all happen? You know?
And since you, yeah, we could ignore them, but it's your community. It's the leaders of this community that are now telling us that we're stupid. We don't know anything. We're lying and deceivers.
Yeah.
And there's no Satan. There's none of that. So we're the opposition. We're the people voicing we're the watchmen that God talks about. That's who we are, because we're the only ones standing up and telling you there's more to this life than discussing these photos. There's a spiritual battle going on. So that's why it's a topic.
And
we haven't changed our position. We're being attacked. And it seems like an organized attack from people that you see on these other channels. And yet, what do? They're on what? I saw one of the their group is on Tucker Carlson. And I don't, a bunch of like mainstream stuff now. And I don't know. It's just, it's so obvious to me now that it's an organized attack.
Yep. What and these seeing these melted buildings and being reminded of what took place maybe in the not so distant past is part of our spiritual journey. We should have already have known this stuff. We should have already have seen it. We should have already have recognized what it was. And we should have been living accordingly all this time. But we haven't. We've been lost in the sauce and deceived under perception, deception. Oh, it's just a mountain. It's just a hill. It's just a volcanic chain. Oh, thermal dynamics on your globe with your molten core. How does all that figure into your flat earth fucking model? How do you now factor in volcanism, okay, and all this other stuff? How does that work on your globe model thermal dynamic thing, putting that on a flat earth? Are you going to explain any of that stuff? I mean, you can't just stay stuck on flat earth and stuck in that ice wall. How come nobody's talking about what is this ice wall? What does it really look like? Where? How come on all these other maps it's showing it ice free? You know, what about these openings that are everywhere? What about the UN flag? Oh yeah, it's a flat earth map, the UN flag. Did they talk about the 8 fucking lines going through it, which match up perfectly to the 8 openings when you overlay it onto the flat earth map from Montalbano, 1595? Because it does. We've done it, right, Chapu?
Yes, yes.
Yeah. Let me talk about the openings and the way out of here and all this other stuff like that and what could be beyond these Terra del Fuego land masses, because it doesn't say Terra del ISO.
Yeah. And do you remember like when they say like ills were all tombs from the natives? Now you know why.
Exactly. And this right here, you know, if it was melted down more, it would just be a hill in the landscape, okay? But this, you can clearly see that there's structure here. It's not totally muffed up enough to where they could label it a hill. This is where archaeology steps in and geology steps back. But once you get to the point where it's like one of the first pictures we looked at back here, which was it? This one here, I think. This. Okay, geology and archaeologists have to slam right into each other at this fucking point, okay? Two worlds colliding right here, just saying.
Well, and the other thing that they always hit us with is, what could possibly melt brick? Well, some kind of event from God that we don't understand that can melt it, because it's not a matter of what can melt it. It's obvious, you can see in some of these examples, it did get melted. So rather than question, could it ever melt? No. The question is, what created it and what used to be the structure, rather than the straw man argument of saying it's impossible to melt brick. Well, you don't know that again. Everybody that tells you an absolute doesn't know shit, and watch out for them.
Yeah.
I'll tell you right now, I could be completely wrong in everything I talk about, but just my research is pointing me in that direction. And just like I was saying earlier, someone doesn't believe my way. Okay, that's their way. But I'm not going to sit here and shit on them and try to make them think that they're completely lost or whatever. And unless you spend money and come to my event, you won't find the truth. That's exactly the opposite teachings I'm learning. Anyways, what?
And that bunker in Russia, I forget the name of it, but there was a supposedly a napalm explosion, and they showed the pictures. I actually have the pictures where the brick is melted. Now, the historical narrative on that is in the 1970s or right around 1970 after the Vietnam War, whatever, they were storing napalm they actually say in the article, a napalm-like substance. They don't even say it was napalm, but napalm gives you an idea of the extreme heat that was involved supposedly in the accident that took place there that melted this brick. It was over 5,000 degrees. Now, whether it was actually X-factored, and they're giving us a fucking historical narrative to go with it because they can't explain it away, and they'll say, oh, it was a napalm accident, or it was really napalm. The point being to that is that bricks can melt. You can see that shit's fucking melted, and it took extreme heat that lasted within hours to get it that way. So, if it's say their narrative's true that it was a napalm like accident that melted that brick, that does not mean that brick can't melt under any other circumstance. Look at all the stuff around you that we showed you so far. I've showed you buildings with bricks that are melted into each other, and then the next brick over is perfectly fine next to the other brick.
And again, just because we see something that was a building that's been melted, and we see something else that looks like a tree stump. Like that, what's that, Devil's Tower? I think that probably was a fossilized tree stump. It looks very similar. So, and then I've seen ones that look like
okay.
I put them on my show. There's some that look like giant elephants. I don't know how you can say it's not. Some look like actual humans. Who knows? But we'll never know. But we can obviously see there's some that look like honest to God bricks are coming out of them. So how can you not just make a blatant statement and say we're all insane because we see
exactly
because
and there's one thing that we can all agree on, at least I would think, not most likely. It doesn't sound like these people who are having all these issues and getting their panties in a twist, but all of us who are into this topic, whether we're right or wrong, was one thing we can agree on. I think whether it's a tree stump, a sleeping giant, or a melted building, these things, these mountains of whatever they are, these heaps of stuff, are not what they are telling us. They've never been what they've told us. The globe has never been what we're on a flat plane, and everything around us was something else. Heat, temperature dictates the state of matter. And apparently the heat went up in here to extreme temperatures and shit melted down like ice cream. Well, the evidence for it is everywhere.
Exactly. No, like CFN said earlier, it's all of this doesn't really matter. This is only to help us see what the lies and what we have been told that it's wrong, and to help you see how to be yourself, how to truly find who you are. You know, it's not about what happened, what really went on and the shape or anything. It's just for you to help you see that you have been lied to about everything. You
know? Everything. Everything has been a lie. And then you have to ask yourself, why? Why would they lie? Why would they lie about the Earth's shape? And that, well, they've made up this whole thing called space with all these balls spinning around in it. And we're supposed to be afraid that one of them might hit us one day. And oh my God, a black hole might suck us up and all this stuff. I mean, all that shit's fake. People base their whole careers, lifetimes on this research that it's not even real. But yet I'm showing you something that's real here. Is this a mountain? Is this a hill? Or is this a building? Or is it all three? What is it? You tell me, geologist.
Yeah.
It was a hill. It was a mountain that dwindled way down to a hill. And then some people came along and carved it out and built some shit on it. That's what happened. I have nothing to see here. I'm gonna see you.
Don't forget the donkeys.
The donkeys in the mud. All right, here we go. Another hilltop mountain right here. Okay. Is this a mountain?
So they said the best thing we could do is we could go up to the top of this mountain and carve little holes in it and live there. That's what they decided.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thanks, Mama. Okay. My mom just was telling me she found my cat, who was apparently two blocks away from my house up a hill where she wasn't supposed to be.
Oh, geez.
She was in dog man territory. Yeah, exactly.
I was just going to say that. That's funny. Your mom and I think alike. I was like, she's looking for dog man.
Okay, this looks like a pretty decent height here. Now, it's not, I'm sure, mountain status, right? Because they have certain elevations that they want to consider something a mountain. But this was a building. It's melted down to the point where you can't recognize anything. This little pocket of survival here that is barely hanging on and surviving, they'll just stick a narrative on it. Some ancient people were here. They carved out this little niche to put their family's bones in as a ceremonial thing to bury them. You know, this crazy stuff.
Are they going to get mad at us now that we think some hills are melted? So now there's like, now they're mad at that too. Hills have never been melted.
Oh, now they're talking about hills. They jumped off a mountain and landed on a hill. Now that's a building. Oh my gosh! All right, what's this? What's going on here? Is this a hilltop, cliff, mountain? What is it? Tell me, please, geologist. Come out and help me out here. Oh, this is an archaeology site. That's what we have here.
And we're not burning bridges. We're standing up for ourselves. If someone attacks you, you're gonna at least stand up for yourself, and that's what we're doing. The people in the Flat Earth community that you're all listening to and loving and going to their events are the ones that are attacking us. Jen,
exactly. Shabu,
myself, Steve, Dottie, they're all being attacked. So whatever.
Yep.
We're not causing division. We're just pointing it out.
I'm pointing out that the trigger word for these people who, you know, is melted buildings or meltology, that really gets their panties in a twist, and it's hysterical. Oh, wow. Look at this. Just look at it, guys. If this would have melted down more, it would look like something you would see out in Utah or something. Okay. But here we can see remnants of windows and doors and all this stuff like that.
Where do you think this is? You know, nobody will
get. I want to say like Iraq or something, maybe.
Yeah, I know. No,
no idea. Where?
This is in China.
No way.
China. Dude, it's China.
But do you see how it just continues on as far as you can see? It's just like described in the Bible. It's the giant buildings that go on forever.
He laid waste to cities, massive cities. He laid waste. They were devastated. They were desolate. This looks desolate to me. Okay. Nothing grows here. It's completely destroyed. It's melted. It's all muffed up. And if it would have melted down even more, they could have got away with some jackwagon geology on this site, but they couldn't do it because there's too much structure still left over, because God wants you to see this stuff. He said, look what could happen to you if you, this is why I named, I have the thumbnail that I have about Sodom and Gomorrah. It was left as an example. The remains that we still see, all this stuff is left as an example for us who come after.
Yeah. They will say to you that all this happened because of water, you know, rain and water, but there's no place that can see one green, like grass, something there. And in this place, I think it rains like one day a year, you know, so it would take a really long time to make this with rainwater, you know.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. I agree with you there. Some stuff.
But why is some of it eroded to the point of destruction, and some of it looks like they just built it yesterday? Yeah. That doesn't make sense either, right?
Yeah, they come in. Now, see, this is what they do in Turkey, too. They take these structures that were originally buildings at one time, that now they're like all in it, like this, right? And they go in and they refurbish them, and they still use them because people used to live here. People used to work here. These were buildings, and they still are buildings. They're just melted and muffed up now. For me, I look at it as this could have possibly be, to a certain extent, a slap in the face to the creator, because the creator destroyed these for a reason. You come along and rebuild it? That's like saying, fuck you. You know what I'm saying? I do what I want, kind of thing. All right, so let's look down here a little bit. There's a nice archway there, okay? You can see that everything, this whole thing is the structure, guys, this whole thing. All this stuff that you see here, these apertures and indentations here, were all upright and windows and doors and stuff like that. It's melted down over itself. And it's also probably here at ground level flowed out down and over other things. Like here, you can see how it was flowing down and over stuff, flowing down and over stuff. Well, those things, those other things are covered up now. Some people call it a mud flood or a brick flood or an ash flood. I don't care what you call it. It's all part of the X Factor event. I think you can't have one without the other. The floodwaters may have came and been the cooling component to this X Factor event because things seem to have solidified mid-melt in many places. You could see it was melting. It's completely obvious, but something stopped it. The heat was taken away. Could that be the cooling of the floodwaters coming in? It could be. I don't know. It definitely fits in there. You mix all this water with building ash flowing all around and covering stuff up. I mean, now what's this? Is this a mountain? Or is this a building? Or is it a building that turned into a mountain? A pile, a heap of melted building right here. That's what we have.
Yeah, exactly. And there is a couple of them. Theories that how it stopped, you know, this the cooling and this the thing. But one that I like is the Hutchison effect, you know, when you change the frequency. Just like when you see cymatic effects, you know,
when there's definitely bricks. I'm sorry, but there's definitely bricks down there, but you keep going. I'm sorry.
Yeah, you know, the cymatics, when you change the frequency, the shape changes instantly, you know, it's not a difference, it just changed instantly. So that's just an effect.
And again, that what you're saying, Shapu, is actually written about in the Bible. Remember when they went around the walls of Jericho and they just made music and noises and they went around it so many times and the whole thing comes down.
Yeah.
So cymatic, is that how you say it? Yeah.
Just sound frequencies, you know. Maybe this is what they mean in the Bible.
The military we know uses that. So we know.
Absolutely, 100%. Yes. Absolutely. Now, come on, Jen. This is just carved. You're going too far with all this. It's just carved. That tells me that you still buy the historical narrative. You know they lie to you. They've lied to you about everything. They lied to you about where you're living, what you're living on. They think you were thinking for however many years of your life you were spinning in space somewhere. Okay, that was all a big fucking lie. You don't think they're going to lie to you about this stuff. You're going to buy the lie that, oh, millions of years or thousands of years ago, some primitive people came along and carved this out. Oh, it was to hide from their enemies and the invaders and all this stuff. Really? And the pyramids are tombs. Sure. Oh, wow. What do we have here? Is this a mountain or is this a building? Let's zoom in and see. It's a mountain. It's a mountain of melted building is what it is. I love it. Look at this. Look at this. Now, clearly, they seem to have rebuilt some of this. It's maybe tourism, bringing it back and stuff like that. But you get a generalized idea of how big and massive this thing was. You can see that up top here, it's completely melted away and dripped down on itself. But it definitely seems to have been restored in certain locations, maybe to bring in some tourism or something like that. That's no small structure right there, guys. That's pretty damn big. All right, what else?
I saw Juan Torres has shown up. So we have more Moai talk, I think you said, right?
Yes, we're going to be showing some
new Moai.
We found Moai cousins of the Moai on the move.
Watch out, Juan Torres.
So, yeah, I'm not sure what's going on with this site. It's very anomalous, very strange looking, and it seems to be the whole structure is made out of this stuff, but it's really damaged in some locations here and everything. I mean, now, this reminds me of the polygonal walls that you would see in Teotihuacan and Tulu, those Mayan sites and different places in Peru and stuff like that. Do you see how when the brick gets warped out and shaped out, or even if it's a molding over it, because in Sacsayhuaman, we showed that the moldings are expanding out and getting larger, which it comes to look like a megalithic structure. But actually, those moldings aren't even very thick. And when you pull the molding off, which they say they can't move these rocks because they're stuck together, they're molded together and stuff. Can you put paper between them? But we found spots where the molding was off and you could see brick under it, right, Shapu?
Yes. Yeah. Almost everywhere.
Again, this looks like that same... Yeah, this is like that. And we'd say, oh, it's polygonal. How did they get them all locked together like that so perfectly and stuff? This is all from heat damage. All right, let's go over here. Here's a larger picture of this. Okay, now we get a better view of what we're looking at here. Well, what came first, the mountain or the brick? You know, I mean, what, is it a mountain? Is it a hill? I don't know. It looks like a structure to me. Looks like it may have been a dome structure of some sort. Again, I want to point out this over here is definite clear structure. We can see that. You move over here to this side, definite clear structure. Yet this is supposed to be the natural geological structure over here. And this is the man-made structure. It's one in the same. The heat was worse over here, clearly. Oh, and then, you know, they come out with their questions. Well, oh, yeah, the heat did this and the heat did that, blah, blah, blah. All you're telling me when you say all this stuff is that you haven't done any of the research. You need to go back into all of our live streams and start watching because you are so fucking late that it's going to take you 2.5 years to catch up. Okay? Just say it.
That's really tardy.
Really, really fucking tardy. And you want to give me some lip about it, too.
Well, no, if you're that late, if you're 2 years late, that's really tardy.
Yeah. So what do we have here? Do we have a mountain that has, you know, carved stuff in it from some primitive culture? Or do we have a whole fucking little city here of houses and buildings that have melted down over themselves and was flowing downward? Which looks more logical to you guys? I mean, you tell me. Put it in the chat. Somebody's carving melted steps. So there's that. You got drippy buildings dripping over each other, flowing down here. All of this was building, and it was all built up. Even here, you could see the apertures of windows and doors and stuff like that. You could see how it was all running down here, running right down all down to here. And whatever was under here is all covered up now because a lot of this stuff goes way down underground. They're still finding more stuff under places like this. What do you think?
The underground of these places look exactly like caverns you see with stalactite and stalagmite every time.
Yep. Yes. So. Now, if you saw one of these columns, right, underground in a supposed cave where the heat was intense at the lower portion of the center of the building, right, these columns would start to melt away. They would start to even pull away from itself on either end and start getting this drippy look. We call them stalactites and stalagmites now. I definitely think that a lot of things that we're seeing in these caves were actually columns and colonnades inside these buildings. Could I be wrong? Sure, I could be wrong. But you go to a cave and with these new eyes and you tell me, does it look all fucking melted? It is. It was melted. And it seemed to all have melted continuously at the same rate of melt. When you go into these caves, you can see it was all melting at the same time.
And to calcify these, like stalagmite, it needs something under, like the drop they're telling you, you know, that there was thousands of years of dropping one drip making these, but you need something below to calcify it, you know.
Agreed. Again, these are not carved, okay? The carved narrative, you have to let go of the carved narrative, okay? Because if you're still living in that headspace, you're gonna still be blinded to what we're seeing because your brain won't allow you to see the truth. But once you see it and you get it, you're never gonna unsee it. And you're gonna be like, those damn meltologists, what have they done to me? And then all your friends are going to think you're crazy. And you came over to the meltology side and you're like, oh no, don't be retarded like those people. Please come back to Earth, flat Earth. Look at this. What's this? Do we have some Anastasi climbing up here, bricking this shit up, making rooms up in this corner here? Or is it melted? It looks melted to me.
There's totally bricks in there. You can see them.
Yeah.
They're great.
So I was telling Seal and Fan Man and Chapu, you know, and I think I might have mentioned it earlier here too, but, you know, God made Adam from the clay of the earth. Bricks are made from the clay of the earth. Everybody wants to know where did all these bricks come from. Hello? 2 + 2 = 4.
Like you said, which came first, the brick building or the mountain, you know?
So. We don't even know where ground level is, guys. If God, the creator, created this realm And he created all of this. This is why he can destroy these cities. Okay? All he's got to do is put out his God frequency.
Can we just, like, this picture alone should be enough to just say, okay, everyone, unbunch your panties. You can definitely see there's bricks and there's melted something there. If you don't want to say melted building, if that upsets you so much, call it something else. Dripping building. I don't give a crap. But you can see there's some melted areas, there's some brick, and then they go into each other. The building becomes the mountain or the hill, and whatever pisses you off, just don't get caught up in the words. A two-year-old could see that something, event happened and created this mess.
Exactly.
Of a mountain.
Exactly. Look at how it's running down here. You know what I think they're salty about is that they didn't figure this out themselves. And they're coming in so fucking late to class that the only thing they could do is ridicule it. Or the other thing.
I just want you to keep looking at flat Earth forever. Let's watch another NASA shoot off. Like, we all believe, we know that is garbage. Why do we keep watching that? It's amazing to me.
Absolutely amazing. These pictures are amazing.
But you know what? We have nowhere else to go. When we turned off the television and stopped watching that, then we went into here. So now the same 10 people do the same freaking show. The people have to watch it. But you know what? I think most people are tired of it. I know I am.
So nothing to see here, just regular sedimentary layers. Geologists will tell you to move on. Don't, never mind all these little holes and openings here in the background, this perfectly square one down here and all this stuff. This is just sedimentary layers. But here, an archaeologist will pop out of one of these windows and say, oh, this was built by primitive people in 500 BC. Nothing to see here. And then the geologist will pop back out down here and say, these are sedimentary layers, nothing to see here. Oh, don't mind the hell. It all goes right into the brick wall right here and stuff, because the archaeologist is going to pop back out this window right here and explain it all away.
How do you stack bricks on something curvy like that?
We'll have an explanation for it. Trust me. They'll call it curvature bricking or something.
Yeah, that definitely couldn't have had an event that melted that. No, that's impossible.
No. Right here is where geologists and archaeologists slam into each other and say, oh, excuse me, I didn't mean to bump into you. You got in my way.
Ancient people, they took their donkeys up a mountain and stuffed some brick into the side of it. I mean, come on, people. What are we doing?
All right, now look at
and
this.
You know what they say? Be careful who you follow, because you don't know where they're going to lead you. Just saying.
Exactly. Or where they're going to lead you away from. That's important as well, because they're going to lead you somewhere, but it's going to be leading you away from something that you should have been probably checking out.
The truth.
Yep. That's
they're
right.
Leading you away from the truth as they tell you they're taking you to see it.
There's nothing wrong. Nothing wrong at looking at other people's work, but keep your road straight, you know? You can look from your
own. And you know what? It's okay to disagree with it as well. It's okay to disagree with my work or this topic or these topics. But condemnation without investigation is the height of ignorance. We are not ignorant, and we're not ignorant to this topic. We have done our due diligence. We've done the research, and we feel confident enough to get on camera and present what we have found. And I have been led to do this. I've been so compelled. This is one of my major topics that I've been covering for quite some time now. Once I figured this out, thanks to Jerry DeCamp and him seeing his live streams, I ran with this because it was so compelling to me. And I feel like I was being led to do this, compelled to do this by the Holy Spirit. I really do, because it's been my passion for 2.5 years now. For somebody to come along and try to poo-poo all over it, like, oh, wait, here, I have a quote to read from you, exactly, from Karen B, by the way. Yeah, let's read a quote from Karen B. Let's do that.
Oh, and real quick. Chris was asking, like, we're not saying there's no crystal that could be a mountain. That's the opposite. See, we're saying rethink. Some are melted buildings. Some might have been giant trees. Some might have been animals. We don't know. But the other side, the leaders of this community, are the ones that are saying we're all stupid for trying to tell you things like this exists.
And we're lying and we're deceiving you and we're misleading you. I've been called a liar. I've been told that Steve has been told that he makes stuff up on his live streams. Here's a quote from Karen B to Steve JMO. Oh, right. idiots discovered all mountains are melted brick buildings. Thank God, now we can all move on with our lives. And it's a laughing emoji. She's very condescending. She called us idiots, okay? You know, Karen, a little slice of humble pie might do you good. Just saying.
We're also, we were told that we're not researchers because we look at pictures and videos and books and stuff. And then I throw back at the people saying that, well, what the hell are you doing? I know I've gone boots on the ground, and Jen and Steve, and I'm sure Shapu has too. But have any of you gone to like the pyramids of Egypt and chipped a little piece off and taken it to a lab and decided? No, you're doing the same thing we are. And hopefully you're finding the information to advance your own knowledge. But no, it's nonsense. It's ridiculous arguments. It's straw man arguments. And it sounds like the flat earth community, the leaders anyways, have turned into globe people. And they're just saying you're a bad person and I hate you, wah, wah, wah. It's really ridiculous. It's like Steven said, they set us back 8 years easily. Yeah. Good job, everyone.
It's good character job. Assassination by trying to, you know, pinpoint me in a video and saying all this stuff about me and then drag netting everybody who listens to my stuff and comes on my shows and roping them into what you just described that you feel I am, like, which is retarded, you know, too stupid to live. I can't even take a shower without possibly killing myself. And I guess I'm a glue sniffer now too. Never said anything negative or bad about anybody. Never started any crap with anybody. I just stay in my lane and do my own stuff. And then I find out this stuff's going on here.
We didn't know we were being fought or attacked until other people told us. We didn't know. It's ridiculous.
No, mainstream doesn't want you to figure anything out. They want you to have the need to follow like a scientist, someone with a white coat, you know, but never to use your own discernment and your own eyes and your own feelings to know what is. They want you to follow them. So this doesn't work.
The creator
didn't make you with eyes to listen to other people. He made you with eyes to see for yourself and to feel it, you know?
I like that.
Yeah, go.
Agreed. Okay, here's a good one.
I was going to say, I saw Ray's in the chat, Ray, and him and Singeman, I guess, are doing a show, and I'm going to be talking to them soon. But you know what? He came at us hard and said a lot of things because he's got that Boston anger. And then he realized, okay, he was twisted around and he repented, apologized, and we're all good. That's all it is. But to continue to hammer at the community that you now want to siphon money from, well, good luck with that. I'm done. So
look at this, guys. Okay, what came first, the mountain or the brick and the archway down here? Okay.
That's funny. Look at that.
Yeah.
What a weird anomaly that is.
Yeah,
a little pocket of survival that God left behind. So you would come along and say, oh, okay, I got it now. But no, the average person would get some jackwagon geology / archaeologist fucking narrative for this thing. But like, there's a reason why these remnants and these pockets of survival were left behind. And it's for us to recognize. And we see it now. And we're trying to show you guys. And I've been showing you for the last 2.5 years. Shapu's been at this very long as well. Mothers have been at it even longer than us. And it's time to wake up to this level of truth. It really is. And really, there was no problem. We were all just steamrolling along perfectly well. Until these people just decided to come in so fucking late. I got to stress that again, so late, and try to trip us all up. Well, it's not going to happen, guys. It's just not.
Yeah, the need for tools to explain our world and our lives has fucked everyone up, you know? You have all the tools in yourself. You need to use it, but people have been pushed far away from their own discernment, you know?
That's right.
Here we have
a concretion. Geologists tell you this is a concretion somewhere.
I don't know what that word is. What's a concretion? That's new for me. What is that?
It's concrete. So someone made it.
Nothing to see here. It's just a concretion. Move along. Are you fucking kidding me? Oh, I love it. I love it. This is Sodom and Gomorrah right here. Okay. It says it's in Mexico, New Mexico. Okay. Not even Mexico. It's New Mexico, but it's got the Sodom and Gomorrah ashy look to it. It's so cooked out that you can barely make anything out. If it wasn't for this ball here, I mean, God only knows what this could have been. The ball in Times Square in this location. I don't know. It looks also like those little balls that they show on Ancient Aliens that have that line going through the rim of it that they say are 250 million years old and aliens must have made it. I really like that.
You remember,
yeah, you know what I'm talking about, Chico.
Yeah, you remember I made like this video of this woman just eating sand with the lens, and it creates all these balls with the eat.
Don't tell me she. Oh, I thought you said she eats sand. I was like, God, what is she? Is she gonna shit out a mountain eating all this sand?
No, then that fish for that. They have fish for that. You showed me that. Karen fish make islands by pooping. That was news to me. That was wild.
Oh, yeah, they have to have an excuse for all these islands out there that look like melted buildings. Oh, parrot fish. They poop out islands, okay?
That was great. I've seen parrotfish. I didn't know that they make islands by shitting. That's awesome.
So you learn something new every time you come to my show.
That's right. As retarded as you are, you still find ways to teach me things.
It's compelling. All right. So what's going on here? Is this a windbreaker? Are we on Mauna Loa? I don't know what's going on here, but we got balloon popcorn bricks mixed with smaller muffed up bricks and janky rock. And then down here, you got some... looks like outer casing molding stones over top of whatever this thing was. It's all muffed up. But there you have it, guys. That's a good one. As you can see, these last three pictures that I snapped were at 6:15 a.m. and 6 a.m. and stuff because I didn't sleep all night, and I was up really, really early because I didn't sleep all night, and I was just getting all this shit ready for the show. Okay, I'm going to go back to this one here. As a matter of fact, I think if I go to the next picture, the circle's not in there, so I can read it better.
And
I
get some water.
I'm going to, absolutely. Oh, let me go back one. I'm sorry. Okay, so it says here, mountains, landform that rises prominently above its surroundings, generally exhibiting steep slopes, a relatively confined summit area, and considerable local relief. Mountains generally are, oh gosh, I can't even read through that thing here, was it? Are understood to be larger than hills, but the term has no standardized geological meaning. It's just a mountain of stuff. It's a large quantity of stuff, of melted buildings stuff.
Yeah.
This is their words, not mine, guys. The term has no standardized geological meaning because it's describing something. A mountain is not a thing. It's describing a thing. And that thing is melted, destroyed buildings. So all these people who want to make fun of us talking about mountains are melted buildings, they're just mountains of melted buildings, okay? And maybe there's mountains of other stuff, too. I think if there was giant people, giant buildings, giant trees, and giant animals, because clearly everything seemed to be a lot more bigger prior to the X Factor event. I'm just saying. Okay, a mountain is something very large in size or quantity, a huge amount, a great heap, a great heap. This is from the 15th century for mountain. And that's it there without my circle around it there. You can see it. Okay. So let me go over here a little bit more into these pictures. See if I have anything else over here. Oh, yeah. That's the comment there that was going on Facebook. I mean, you know, whatever. I thought this was interesting. Chapeau, are you near this area at all? Mount Babel, Quebec? Yeah.
It's really far, but it's in my country.
Yeah. Now they said the reservoir going around it. Now originally this is supposed to be a meteor crater. So there's no space, so there can't be a meteor crater. Let's just cross that off. Now meteor crater out in Arizona, Okay, I don't know what the flat earthers are saying about that, but clearly there's so yeah, obviously that's not a crater. So what could it be? Okay, so we're going to tackle Meteor Crater one of these days because I have found a lot of brick ruins all around Meteor Crater.
This place is there's no hole there. You know, I don't know how it can be a crater. When I first heard that this was they classified this as a crater, ow, because it's just a flooded. And this place is full of hydroelectric dams. They probably just flooded all this place up some time ago.
You cover stuff up.
Exactly. Because when I wanted to go research this place like 10 years ago on Google Earth, all the close-up pictures are blurry. You know, when you go sometimes, you can go places, this place, you can't see anything. You cannot see anything of this place. Wow. And it's so remote that almost nobody goes there.
And you can see this thing supposedly from space. They say that, you know, their high satellite photos, this is one of the things that they can spot very easily from high altitude. So it is massive.
Yeah.
It is massive. All right. What else we got here? Okay. So Shapu made this up for me. These are the arcs. Noah's Ark. And you know, it would have been really good, Shapu, if we had that Masonic one where they're chiseling away and that arc is off in the water next to them, you know, that would have been cool too in this. But anyway.
Oh, yeah. Way to go, Shapu. Thanks.
That was my fault. I should have been So here's the arc, right? This is X-Factor stuff here we're talking about. Here they got them. Okay, it's always presented to us in a childlike manner, Noah's Ark. It's imprinted onto us at a very young age, and I'm going to tell you why. Because if we learned this scenario at an older age, it would make no sense and we would not buy it. This is why when you walk into school, the flat earth isn't sitting there waiting for you, the globe is. They imprint that on you at a very, very young age, and they also do the same with Noah's Ark. This is always why it's drawn in a very childlike manner as well. Well,
did they say Bigfoot on this one or what?
Return what is that?
What?
Yeah, look, there's
what are these people?
Can you make that larger?
What is that? They're definitely hairy people. They must be, I don't know.
I guess they're trying to show you evolution on the Ark. Well, Enoch was covered with red hair, but geez, yeah, what the heck?
Is that where a red herring comes from?
Red herring?
I don't know. That's red hair, red herring.
What are those guys? That's funny.
I don't know. Isn't it crazy that we just now picked it up out of this picture?
Exactly. I never saw it before.
Oh, look. There's there is a reindeer in there.
That's bizarre. Okay.
Okay, so this
two Bigfoots on no wonder there's Bigfoot and Dogman. They were on Noah's Ark. That one has a staff. Are they saying Moses Noah was really hairy? Is that what they're saying? Is that no one is?
He does have a staff. Isn't he a goat herder? So they're saying that these monkey men are goat herders.
Oh God! They're trying to add evolution into the story of Noah.
That's just shameful. It's shameful.
This is great. Boy, this show is retarded.
It's so retarded. All right. So this hippopotamus has a bunch of little birds on them. I don't know what they're doing, but they all look happy. So that's good. Again, it's presented in a very childlike manner, this whole arc thing. Now, we know that they've messed with the Bible and they've added to and they've taken away. And I think that they've taken away more than they've added to. I think they're taking away some of the arcs and only leaving us with one. But yet everywhere across the plain, all of these cultures seem to have stories of a flood story, which also involves an ark. So there had to have been more than one ark. And I think we're looking at some of these here. Here's another depiction of the ark with the ramp going up with the animals and stuff. There's probably all kinds of crazy stuff in here that we haven't even picked up on.
Well, is that a horse or a unicorn? Because, you know, unicorns in the Bible now.
I just looked at that. I thought that was a unicorn, too. I wasn't sure if that was right here, right? Off to the right. Yeah. Okay, and then you have this picture here, which is also a depiction of one of these supposed prison ships. These people don't look like they're in prison. It looks like they're hanging their clothes. They're going on a journey. They've been on the boat for a while. And guess what? We've arrived. And let's get these people are coming off the ship and coming down here and getting on these boats. You see they're leaving out and coming down the steps. They're not going on it and get it's not a prison ship. Like they tell us these are prison ships. That's not the case. At least I feel like it's not the case. And so we're seeing evidence of these arcs that are all over the place that nobody's ever talked about or brought up in any of the live streams that I've ever listened to across the board. And I'm not bragging or anything. I'm just saying this apparently is one of those truths that need to come out, and it needs to come out now because this connects to whatever this X factor was. The whole flood story connects to it.
Yeah, exactly. I mentioned, I watched a 2-hour video from UAP from a couple of years ago. It was going through all these old ships and none in 2 hours, he never mentioned one arc and showed one of these ships. And I written to him and you never heard of these prison ship and you didn't show any in your presentation and never wrote back.
He never even, exactly. A lot of people have told me, and for me even, me and you doing this live, this is the first that we've even come across it in all the years of our different research and stuff like that.
I've never seen it before I saw it.
I know, when I mentioned it to you the first time, you never heard of it. So. You know, I've been looking into this like 5 years, 6 years ago. This is the Central Park.
Oh, is that what that was there?
Yeah, the next one will be the Central Park too.
Yeah, I don't know why it's not loading for me. Oh, I knew it was going to do there that. Okay. So I'm going to come off of this screen share. Ceiling Fan, I know you had some stuff that you wanted to present as well.
Yes.
So I'm going to send it over to you here. Is there a comment on the screen or did it come off? Because it still looks like that comment's up on
33 is saying lol. Is what I say. She always says that.
Thank you, DJ. I'm a little back on the comments here. I had to scroll up a little, but I appreciate that. And everybody else who's here commenting, I'm sorry I'm not putting any comments up on the screen like I usually do, but I'm trying to get through the pictures. I'm having a hot flash right now, guys. Oh my gosh. Whew. Okay, Ceiling Fan, you ready to go?
I'm pulling some stuff off of my computer right now. So give me a second here. It's not working. Of course it's not working.
Shapu,
I didn't know you're throwing it over so fast.
I'm sorry. Shapu, I just sent you something from Juan Torres. It looks interesting. I'll let you open it up and check it out. See if we want to share that on towards the back end of things here. Yeah. So I'm not able to open it up on my side right now. See how red I am? This is a hot flash right now. I'm like sweating really. I'm melting.
You're melting?
No, I'm melting. Oh my gosh.
All right, why isn't this working?
God, we have 67 people here.
Whoop, whoop. That's whoop, excellent. Whoop. Extract.
We're not here to fight and argue and debate about none of this stuff. We're just showing what we're finding. And if you want to mock us and ridicule us, you keep doing what you're doing. Okay. You do your thing. Okay. I'm just saying it's not helping anything in this community. If you decide you don't like my work or there are research, you can just change the channel. Okay. Yeah. It's no big deal. No skin off our back. But if you want to start slinging mud and building ash at us, expect a little blowback because, we're standing up for what is righteous here, okay? I'm not misleading people. I'm not trying to twist people's arms to see what I see. I show you what I got. Shapu shows you what he's got. Ceiling Fan, it's obvious to see. Like you said, you can't unsee this stuff. It's like Flat Earth. You literally cannot go back. You can never go back into the Matrix and act like you don't see this stuff anymore.
Agreed. Sorry, I'm almost there.
No problem. I want to say hi to the chat, but my chat has suddenly disappeared on me for some reason. I'm having little glitches on StreamYard here.
I just the video. It's about like the Great Lakes, and looks like there's things buried under the Great Lakes, and he talks about comets and things. It's a 17-minute video, but it's from mine.
Okay. What I wanted to show was, see if it's here. Shapu sent me this thing about etching. And see if I can bring this up on this screen. I don't know why that's not.
Queen of Swords, yes, you are late, but welcome. I'm glad you're here. You have to stay after.
You missed a lot.
Yes.
Okay, so maybe I just need to stick this in this file over here. That's probably the issue I'm having. I'm sorry.
Yeah, Angela Carson, I agree. We seem to be getting smaller each reset, or from the last reset, of course, it would definitely seem that the meek have inherited the earth. Like the meek, the smaller people, I don't know. Does seem like we've gotten smaller. Things have gotten smaller.
All right, get rid of that screen. Pull this up. And okay. So this is a couple things I have here.
All right.
Share screen with audio. I think it's sharing.
Okay, so you'll have to mute yourself if you play audio. I'm sure you know that.
Yeah. Well, mostly I just talk. So am I sharing now?
Yeah, I'm putting it in right now. There we go.
Okay. So it was interesting. First of all, I wanted to say I came across this, which I didn't remember reading in the Bible, but apparently David takes to Samuel, or to the king rather, to Saul, a bunch of foreskins. He wants 100 and he gives him 200. Now, why am I bringing this up? Because first of all, it seemed weird to me. And second of all, if you look at the Statue of David by Michelangelo, the thing that he used, the slingshot, is now becoming a giant penis with balls.
So muffed up. Okay. When I first saw this, I was like, what the fucking shit is
when
going on?
I first saw it, it kind of looked like it. Now it's straight up. It's obviously the head of a penis, and now it has testicles and like veins. It never had this shit. That's supposed to be the sling he used.
So he used the sling of a giant's balls to kill another giant?
No. What are you referring to? No. He used a sling to take a rock and smote the giant Goliath. And then Michelangelo supposedly, in this reality that we currently live in, this nightmare we're in, now Michelangelo decided to merge the two stories, the one where David cut off 200 foreskins for some ungodly reason, and now he's merged it and made the actual sling a penis.
It almost looks like a snake in a way. But
they don't exist.
Dude, is that like a vein in there too? Like the vein that pieces have right there? Because that looks like
what I'm seeing. I don't know. Nowhere in that looks like a slingshot.
It's a petrified penis.
So there's that. Okay. Oh, and the other thing it should be on here, but he's apparently David or the statue circumcised, and if he was Jewish, he wasn't supposed to be. So that's a weird anomaly. But in any case, let's get off of David and the foreskin.
But that penis looks circumcised as well.
Well, that one did, yeah. Oops, where did I go?
The one on his shoulder and the his are both circumcised.
Yeah. Okay, so let me stop screen sharing. I'm lost. I'm completely lost. Don't know where I am. Okay. My screen stopped there. Okay. So I have a question real quick before I do this. So reading the book of Job, so I come across this very famous saying, because we have all heard it, even if you don't know the Bible. It's about, he says, because he used to have stuff and now it's all gone. He says the Lord does something and then the Lord does something else. You know that saying about he had a bunch of stuff and now it's gone? The Lord
giveth and the Lord taketh away.
Okay, why would you ever say it that way? Because apparently it's never been that. And I double checked with my actual KJV. And when you go on here, instead of, you see in my screen sharing, instead of the Lord giveth, Lord taketh away. See,
I have to bring you back here on screen share. Hold on. Here we go. I don't know where it's at. It's coming. There we go. All right, you're up.
Okay, so you see where it says the Lord giveth, the Lord taketh away, Job 1:21. That's what everyone's like writing. That's what everyone seems to know. Even if you don't know the Bible, well, no. If you go to Job 1:21, he says, naked I came out of my mother's womb, and naked I shall return thither. The Lord gave, past tense, and the Lord hath taken away. Past tense. See, the other way, the Lord continues to give, and when he wants to, he can take it. But this, it's over. He already did it, and it's done. It's changed. Uh-huh.
And life was like a box of chocolates.
Right. So then I was looking into something else, and you hit me up and said you want to talk about mountains. So there's something about the mountains. There's these mountains called the Smoky Mountains, mm-hmm. and they're now spelled S. M-O-K-Y. Here, I'll bring it up. Smoky Mountains. All right. Right? Smoky Mountains. And look, it switches you. Great Smoky. There's no E. See? Okay. But then, check this out. So I started looking into stuff. Here's the smoke, right? What's smoke? The definition. We know what smoke is, right? You with me so far? I know we're slow in this class. I typed in Smoky.
I'm a little mentally challenged, so I've heard.
I typed in Smoky, and that is now what we used to thought of as hazy. What I used to think of as the word smoky with the E.
Uh-huh.
It's now a smoky is an officer of a highway patrol or a state police car. Oh. Like the movie.
But Smokey the Bear.
Right. Well, no, he's Smoky now.
Right. No, exactly. So, yeah.
Yeah. So now Smokey only exists in what was that movie? Smokey and the Bandit. It's now an officer highway state patrol car. Because what I remember is, man, it's awfully smoky outside. It's Smokey now. So there's that. So it's not just the mountains now. This word smoke has now completely changed to smoky, unless you're talking about a cop.
My cat's name was Smokey, and we used an E in his name.
Well, you messed up.
Apparently, he was Smokey this whole time. He was Smokey. I didn't even know my cat. I'm so retarded. I didn't even know my own cat's name this whole time.
Yeah, you messed up. You did.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, so Smokey the Bear has now changed to Smoky Bear, right, Nayika? Smoky Bear. And Stacy, yeah, if the foo shits, is the way I see it. You can live up to your name, I guess. So it's sad. It really is. I know we make light of it because we're being attacked, but it's sad. Because obviously anybody that's followed me for a while knows that these people meant a lot to my awakening too. But hey, it's part of the growth process. The wheats and the tares and the chafe, which is fine because they don't believe in any of that anyways. So I'm having to move on and just stay in my lane as I always have. So here I am.
Yep.
Gotta stay in your lane.
That's right. We've been smacked down to make sure we stay in it, didn't we, Jen? Although I think Steve's the best at it. Man, I don't want him against me ever.
Oh, yeah. Dude, Steve's awesome.
He's like a ninja when he fights. He just gets you in strike and he's gone like a snake. If they
like.
All right, so Mountain Builders don't exist and neither do snakes. Yes, sorry, go ahead. What?
I just sent you something, Chapu, which is another proof of a melted building that is portrayed as a natural land formation.
I forgot I had pictures that I downloaded. That was the whole
thing. Okay, well, you get them ready. We're going to show this one real quick, and we can go right back to that.
Yeah. Spent all that time downloading them that I didn't show them. It's kind of stupid.
Yeah, we're definitely going to go there for sure. Well, we may take a break here at some point.
Yeah,
we'll close. Oh, you can open it for them. Yeah, or just let them out the door. Okay, so here we have a picture. What is this? The title here. Can you read it, Chapu? It says sandstone monolith in the Black Sea. Okay, that's what they're calling this thing, a sandstone monolith. We already know sandstone, especially red sandstone, is melted red brick. We've already talked about that on many live streams. But click on that picture again, Chapu, and then we're going to scroll down through the other pictures. You clicked on it the first time. Yeah, there you go. This is pretty amazing looking here. You can talk through this, Chapu. I know this has been on Mountains or Melted Buildings, and I think there was a video of somebody that actually walked past this thing, and you can see when they look at. I'll just let you finish. Go ahead.
No, go ahead. I was just thinking that I'm the one that put up that video.
Okay. Do you remember a long time ago I was asking you about this video? I kept trying to describe it. You can tell in the video where that this wall was attached to whatever else is on behind it on the shoreline there, and it has separated and pulled. When this stuff was melting, it was melting and pulling away from itself and spreading out. And this was left. This is a pocket of survival. This was left for us to see. It's got a window in it right there, for Christ's sake.
You had a picture on the other side, you can really see more of the melt. On this side, there's not really left, but on the other side, there's much more like a drippy stuff.
Yeah, I wish I could find that video. That was such a good video, and it's really, really good proof because that person walks just right past it, shows the other side, and also shows the coastline wall where this thing was attached to.
Yeah, I can't remember it so long ago, and it was in Russian, so I don't.
Yeah, can we scroll down and see the other pictures that go with this? Is there more below it?
No.
Maybe there wasn't. Okay, so click back, go back a page, and we'll scroll down from the Pinterest one, I guess.
They call it Sail Rock. We can go, make a search if you want.
Okay. Okay, yeah, that's good because you can see the other part of the wall there behind it.
I cannot go zoom on it. Maybe this one. Yeah. All right.
So there you go, guys. These anomalies are left all over the place for us to see. Of course, this is why they brought in geology in the late 1800s after the last reset to explain away all this stuff so we never remember what happened. That's just amazing. Yeah. Now look at that.
This is wow. Further down the coast.
Look at that. Right. All right, RT, thanks for hanging out with us. I appreciate you coming by and hanging out for a little while. There you go, guys. There's the rest of the structure right there. You can see the brick pattern, everything. And this is classified as a natural formation, okay? Oh, that's kind of on the other side of it a little
bit. Yeah, the other side, it looks like it's more drippy.
Yeah.
But I cannot zoom in.
Yeah, click that one there. Yeah. Look at that, guys. Look at the brick pattern. You can see it. And it was a part of the rest of it off to the left side of it here.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Yeah, all this coastline is crazy.
Okay, so I'm going to send you something else now, real quick. We'll go over this other thing that I want to show, because this site here, I was talking about melted obelisks recently. Good picture right there with the brick pattern, Shapu. Really good. And look at that perfectly square window.
Oh, this is there.
So I talked about melted obelisks recently. This was another site. Now, you know, this looks like a giant penis, I know, but still, it's a melted obelisk, in my opinion. These large standing monolith stones. If we scroll down from this picture, I think we'll see other ones as well. Okay, here you go. You can see one right there, that big one that kind of looks like it's twisting sideways. Yeah, that one there. Let's make that one big. That was used in the documentary that Jerry had done, When the Buildings Cried. That clearly was melting and twisting. It looks obelisk-ish to me, because it's got the right angle corners there that we're looking straight on at. This may have been a giant type of obelisk that was melting and twisting as it was melting. We can scroll down from that one, see if there's any more. Might have to. I thought there was more in here.
No, just go back to the.
Okay. Yeah, good. Look at these interesting structures. There's another one. Okay. There's the one on the right hand side there. There's that one. And there's a few other ones down here, but these are all melted structures. Wow, look at that one.
Those kids ever get out? They're stuck there to this day.
They're petrified. Okay, there's those polygonal structures right there. You can see those. Yeah, those ones there. These are just moldings that have expanded and ballooned out. And this is why you can't fit a paper, even a slice of paper, between these what they call giant boulders or megalithic structures, because they've been melted together. There you go. There's one there as well.
Yeah. So how do they describe? They just say the Incas were amazing. They were able to carve these things and haul them up with donkeys. Is that what they're saying?
Yep. Okay. Hold on.
Why wouldn't they make them just easier to connect, like blocks? Why would they make it like Tetris? It doesn't make any fucking sense.
Nope. And there's like a small one just like right here that.
Yeah. Hey, can we just make this? No. I got an idea. Let's make this giant notch in here. Well, what the fuck? Why? And look at the bottom of it. It's a point. It's like a little point.
Shapu, I did not mean to call you. I can't even hang it up. I hit the wrong button. I'm sorry.
But look at that one before we were rudely interrupted by the teacher. Look at that one, Shapu. At the bottom, it has a point coming down. You see that? Yeah. It's like a shield almost. Hey, let's make a square. No, let's make a shield like Captain America. I mean, what the heck? Oh, look at that. Did you do that, Jen?
Do what?
You turned it green like that? Or is that Shapu? You did that?
No, it's a gift. I guess it's just.
Oh.
It's showing the eight sides of it.
Yeah, I was impressed cool. with your technology there, Jen. I thought you were doing it. It's like, wow.
I cannot tell a lie. What am I looking for here? Oh, the MOA.
Stop looking at the thing on the right. Let's look at the building. Why do they see? That's why we live in Satan's world. You got all these brick things, and then they just got to throw like a half naked someone. You know what I mean? It's like constant in your face.
Yeah.
All right, Shapu.
That one's got stairs in it. Look at that one.
Oh, I see it. Look at that. Now, who's going to do that? What? Are you kidding me?
It's Tetris. I'm telling you, they got inspired from Tetris by looking at this stuff. Yeah, look at that. What's that?
Crazy looking.
I would have killed that architect. No, it's spending way too much time and money to do these stupid things. No, but 1,000 years from now, people will like go, wow, how'd you do that?
So here we have some relatives of the Moai. Yes, the Moai have cousins around the world. And I just thought it was interesting because we're always talking about the Moai and everything. But yeah, I didn't realize how many relatives they actually have around the world.
But you know what's fascinating about the Moai? We've watched this change. First, of course, they got hats. And then I saw some that had weird eyes. Then they all got long ears. Then they all started touching their junk. There's a lot of
And then they got nipples. They got nipples now. Hard nipples.
Yeah. There's a lot of like sexual perversion happening in not just the society, but also in our history, you know? So how long before the other Moai are going to start touching? What is, you know, it's so weird.
Now
they're underwater. We found them underwater.
Moai, now man, they don't mess around.
Now they have cousins. Juan Torres' worst nightmare is coming to life. But
you're going to go outside one day and you're going to see a Moai sitting on your front lawn.
Yeah, Dogman's coming for you and Moai's coming for him.
I have not heard a peep out of Dogman around here so far. And I have been listening, guys. Haven't heard anything. I know my cats have been freaked out a few times about something out there, but I don't know what it was. And a neighbor down the road from me had found 2 footprints outside his window, and they were like barefoot footprints, but they were kind of like in this muddy grass, so it was a little hard to make it out. And there was also some scratches on his screen, 4 distinct mark scratches. Something had to be standing to scratch down this screen. I seen it. I was there because I walked down there with my mom. But there's something around here for sure.
Jen, will you pull up that shot? The M files just put up.
Okay, hold on. Here we go.
There you go. Exactly.
Mentions mountains melting. Yep. I was going to bring that up too. Psalms 97:5. Somebody used the word mountains instead of buildings in the scripture, but I just explained too. Okay, look, mountain, even from the 1500s, only meant a pile or a massive pile or heap of something. It's a mountain of stuff. It's not. So I think there's a translation issue there. When you look at
she's agreeing, or he, whoever the M files are, they're agreeing. It's proven in the Bible, as we've been told. It doesn't say it's in there.
Yeah, the word melted is in there on many different things. We're having to deal with cities, people, buildings, earth itself.
God does a lot of things with fire and brimstone. Just ask the Sodom and Gomorrah people if they were around.
Yep,
mountain, just an amount, you know, is just missing the A in front.
Yes. And on one of the maps that we showed a while back, Shapu, I forget which one it was, it said Vesuvius Mons on it. It didn't say Vesuvius. It didn't show a volcano. It showed a few rolling hills, if you remember, and it said Vesuvius Mons. They're mons. They're mounds. That's a mound, like a mountain. It's a mound of stuff. It has no connection to a volcano. And if this thing went off in 79 AD, as the historical narrative wants you to believe, there should be a volcano there, not mounds, right? And that was when we first saw it show up on one of the maps before it started showing up as a volcano itself. One of the 1600 ones, I think it was, or close to 1700s, mid-1700s or something. Yeah. 1725, something like that.
And they had to draw a picture of it too on the map.
And this is when they started educating people on what this new thing was, because they weren't around before. Volcanoes don't exist into the capacity that they want us to believe they do when their thermodynamic system with a molten core on the globe model.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yes. So, all right.
Well, I do have those pictures if you want to see them.
Yep, absolutely. We're ready to go.
Okay. Let's see. Screen share.
63 people here. I wonder how many of them are watching just to make fun of us tomorrow.
Yeah, maybe. Who cares? We know their fruits, as you say.
That's okay, right.
Can you see this? Am I on screen?
Yes. Here we go.
Okay. So this is the etching that Chapu sent me. And then, of course, I actually was given God's grace to actually go here once. And so this was the pizza I ate. It wasn't actually that good.
Which one is it? The pizza? Oh, it's a,
this is the pizza, and that's the pizza. That's a piece of pizza.
Pizza, pizza.
You get it?
Pizza, little pizza. Caesar.
Yeah. Little Caesar. Yeah. That's where little we live Caesar. In. Yeah.
It's a piece of pizza from the Little Caesar. Yeah.
So you can see. Let's see. Can we make this one? Yeah. Okay. So I was trying to match up what you got on here. And so let's see. I think it goes this way. Click. It's not doing anything. Why isn't that working?
Well, don't you hate it when that happens?
Yeah, it was working fine. Oh, there we go. Wait. There. Okay. Here we go. All right. So that, I don't know. I'll make these larger, but I was just seeing if I could compare them. Let's see.
So okay, all these so buildings got, aren't there anymore.
No. Or are they? You got some of them. This thing, I think, is this.
Oh, right? Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So that's that. So then this building must have been this other picture here. Okay. And we can look at it, but I didn't even think of this until I looked at it for these pictures. They have an actual fallen angel there. So we'll discuss that. We'll show you that in a second. This is looking up the wall of this ancient castle that's not even depicted in here that I can see. So I'll show you those in a minute. And then this, maybe over here. It's hard to say. Let's see. Here's that old castle. Okay, so that definitely is now this building.
Yeah.
Looking this way. And okay, so let me get rid of this one and make this larger here. Okay. So this castle, which was directly across from the Leaning Tower of Pisa, like if you see where my arrow is, if you went this way, this castle was over here. Oops, not that one. This thing.
This one, yeah.
And look what you got in here. What's going on here?
Oh, is that some red brick?
They just decided that this one spot will cram some in, and maybe this fell. I don't know what's going on. Someone put in a security system. But they really didn't describe much about this thing. These gates were massive. Look how tall that is. I mean, the human's right about here. So why such a big gate? Were there horses that big? Anyways, next. Go over here. I just thought, I don't know. Maybe I thought it was a little interesting because I had the same buildings that we saw in that ancient etching. Some of them still exist. Here's the side of this wall. Okay, first of all, you got a piece of red brick right there.
I mean, just looking at that right there, geologists could say that's just some kind of natural outcropping rock wall.
To me, it looks like you talk about. It's heated. It's pockmarked.
And look at the square window. It looks just like what we saw at the Black Sea on that, what do they call it? The sail monolith that we just showed?
Yeah.
With the square window sticking out of it? Yeah, look at that.
So... is that all in that one? And yeah, look at this. This is nothing to see here, just telling you where we live.
Wow, with the fallen angel. Now, so the Tower of Pisa took 200 years, 199 years to build. The Leaning Tower of Pisa. They couldn't get this shit right in 199 years, but they built the World's Fair in 18 months.
Right.
There's older cathedrals and buildings that took less time than this Leaning Tower of Pisa. You can look it up for yourself, guys. It took 199 years to build, and they still couldn't get it right. Are you kidding me? There's something else going on with these. The whole narrative is all muffed up. It's ridiculous in so many different areas of the narrative. When you start breaking down his story, you can see the ridiculousness of it all.
I mean, think of the time it took to not only build this monstrous structure, but just each one of these carvings. Absolutely. All over it. I mean, come on. It's like a 3D printer kind of stuff.
Even if they were Yeah, even if they were like pre-made moldings that they transported to the site and built it this way, it would take technology and time, and they did not have that. They didn't even have roads, okay? And all the pictures were all muddy roads, but they're bumping out this stuff.
Yeah, we live in a mud hut and there's no road. Shouldn't we work on that? No, we've got to make this temple like crazy good. We've got to.
Yeah, none of us are going to live in this building. None of us are going to ever live here and all this stuff. We're going to build it, you know, because we want to honor God. That's it. But you're going to live in the hut over there. You can't even get plumbing or electricity or nothing.
What are these missiles coming out of it, too? Is it like some kind of armory?
That's crazy. So
there's that thing. Okay. There were more. I don't see them there. So maybe I messed up something. Let me look here again. Yeah, here you go. See, look, this is his castle. Wow. I don't know anything about this castle. And that has been filled in with red brick. But the size of these doors here, here's some humans sitting there. So if they stood up, maybe the head's right about here if they were standing. So who's walking in this?
Exactly. Who's walking in that? Oh, well, you know, they had elephants and they needed them big high arches to ride on their elephants through these arches. Crazy Italians, they love their elephants.
There's the square tower. It's in the etching, but looks like it's much taller.
Oh, there's one. Where's the other one?
Okay, so I think we saw all of those. Oh, there's that one.
That one's crazy.
Which one? The
wall. Yeah, that's just crazy.
Yeah, that was, I was on the, you know, looking up, and it's massive. And like, it's now that I see things, how do you unsee it? Look at the brick lines and stuff in there.
And then how many times have we seen something like that they tell us is a natural formation, even on the sides of riverbanks and up in Mount Sheha? I've seen things that look just like this. And here they're admitting that clearly this is an archaeological site. It's an ancient site or whatever they call it. They're not saying it's a natural formation.
No, but what I'm saying is so you know this is brick and it looks red. And you know that this looks like it's melting and you still see the brick line. Mm-hmm. So I can deduce that would maybe be a melted brick with heat. You can see the bubbling and So I could deduce that some are melted brick. That's all. That's all we've ever said on this channel or your channel, and that's all we'll ever say. But, yeah. But there's a lot of people trying to tell you that God and Satan is not a war and we're not in a spiritual battle. And yet, why are they having things like this showing you there's a fallen angel statue? Just saying, all the other people that seem to be running this world, they all do look at CERN and the opening of CERN. It was just a whole bunch of satanic dancing and stuff. They never proved to you a hydrogen collider smashing things and creating. Who's ever seen that? No one. You could see a cartoon. Oh, just like satellites in space. So, no, if you're telling me that there's no snake and there's nothing in the garden, there's no devil, well, Bill Cooper warned me about that. The trick of the devil is he's going to make you think he doesn't exist, or he's going to make you scared of him, which you shouldn't be if you know Jesus, or he's going to keep you stupid and tell you not to look at this stuff. So that's all I'm saying. Yeah.
But who makes a giant parade with all these stuff just to present a...
What was the point? Yeah, if they don't believe in it. But yeah, anyways, so I think that was all the pictures I had.
Of good that. Stuff. I like it.
Good looks.
Good looks. I wish Steve was able to make it. I miss him. I haven't done a stream with him in forever.
Throw some prayers for him. He's having he had a few little issues, but he's, you know, doing well. But just those things actually do something, people. Prayers really work. So.
Absolutely. Especially if the person is on the receiving end of it, receiving as well and being grateful as well. So a lot of people, you'll say you're going to pray for them, but they may not believe in it the way you believe in it or have the faith. I don't even like to use the word believe a lot of times. You have to have faith in this stuff. You have to have the full intention and know that, you know, God's going to take care of this. in your own, because we're co-creators in this. Jesus said, what's it say? Matthew, what was that verse? A ceiling fan man, if your mind's eye be single, your body be full of light. You can do everything that I can do. You want to walk on water? You got to be a light body. You want to heal the sick? You got to be a light body.
Well, don't forget. So Peter, in the stories, he denied Jesus. And then the next time he sees him after, because after he goes, you know, and dies on the cross, he actually comes back for a little bit and walks with the disciples again. And so when Peter sees him, he wants to I think maybe I'm mixing up the timeline, but I know there's a part where Peter runs out. He started swimming, runs out to see Jesus. And he's like, Jesus tells him he can walk on the water. And he does, until the water gets all rough. And then he freaks out and he takes his eyes, what, off of Jesus, and he starts to sink. And that's what that's like. Everything in the Bible is like parables to teach us, right? He says, if you have the faith of a mustard seed, you can tell a mountain to move. And so what does he mean by that? If you look at a mustard seed, it's tiny. And if you look at the plant or tree, whatever comes out of it, it's huge. And so the idea is this is what I'm processing lately. Because like people keep asking me, why does this bad thing happen? Why does that bad thing happen? Did God check out? Well, no, God's in charge of everything. So why do bad things happen to good people? We pray differently when things are bad versus when things are good. That's the first thing. If things are bad, everyone's on their knees, even people that don't believe. So that's the first thing. Now, the second thing is it's a muscle. Your faith, your way out of this place is your faith. And if you don't exercise it, then it's never going to get stronger. So maybe something happens in your life and you're like, I don't get it. Why do I deserve? Why is this happening to me? Why? Instead, you look at it and say, okay, whatever the reason is, I know you're there. If you can't fix it, or if I can't fix it, help me through it. And then let him help you. And then once that happens and you get through it, because we always do, know this. Now it's not just going to be smooth sailing, because then it's not helping you again. Mm-hmm. Remember, teach a fish. So you might have another struggle, and the new one might be harder than the last one. And that's when you're like, I can't take anymore. And then you find a way through it. I mean, each one of us has had this happen time and time again, and each one seems worse than the last. And it's just like if you're going to exercise a gym, you got to go to it. You can't sit back and say, why isn't anything happening? So we have to do that little bit ourselves. We have to give that side, our side, which is faith and prayer. Those are the things we're supposed to be doing. And if we do that, then we can let him take on our problems. Because if God's on our side, no one can be against you. So this is a wonderful system. Once you figure out how to work it, it's just really difficult. Because the only way you get your prayers answered is you have to pretty much get as close to righteous as you can. Because if you're on unstable ground, then there's no point. And the thing is it has to be in God's will and his laws. And if you fit those, he doesn't say he might do it. He says he will do it. It might not be your time frame, but it gets done. And then that's where we come in with the faith. We have to say, we can't keep looking at our watch and going, well, it's been a day, nothing's happening. That's where the faith comes in. Because if we have that, Jesus says, what? We can walk on water and move mountains. And so instead of keep looking up and going, wow, I wonder what the moon is made of cheese, or if it's a light, or if it's a conch, we need to start figuring out, how do we get this power of manifestation through God? Yeah. That's what I see. That's the next level for me. And this history that you're discovering helps prove that's what we need to do. Because we're not here. It's fun. We can have fun here. But at the end of the day, if I turn this off, it's not about fun. It was about hopefully getting message out, because God put it in my heart. I needed to do it. And when he tells me I'm done, then I'll move on to something else. Absolutely. But I like having fun, and I like having these friends here. And the one thing I won't do is shit on you all if you have a different opinion of me. That's just the way it is.
And I welcome disagreement, as long as you're, you know, doing it in a nice way and not a condescending way and calling people names and stuff like that. At least take the time to check out our research. If you disagree with it, that's okay. If you want to, you know, make your own video about what you see and how you see it and stuff like that and what you think happened or whatever, because We don't know. And that's part of the problem. They don't want us to know what happened in the past. They want to keep us disconnected. NASA, the only thing they've ever done is put space between us and the creator, made us insignificant, put us in an ever expanding space, all this stuff. They work hard at what they're doing to keep us disconnected from our true nature, the true nature of our reality, and the true nature of the creator and how we're connected to it. We're links of the earth and we're co-creators here. And we have the power of the creator within us, but we are disconnected from it. We're not engaging that free will of wanting to be a part of being a co-creator with the creator. And this is how manifestation happens. You know, this is why you have the dark arts and what they do, because they understand manifestation. They're using it for negativity and stuff like that. And they're keeping us stifled from our creativity and manifestation abilities, but keeping us disconnected from Jesus and the creator, and then get us in all these religious wars. I started reading some of the Quran and I cannot believe how much it's just like our Bible. What are people fighting about? What is this religious fanatical stuff? I don't get it. So...
A big problem with people, they always want to know the why, always thinking why is this, why is that, instead of just letting go and let the answers come to you and you'll know. You know, you if you always try to search for answers, anything, you're like making a resistance, you know, you're resisting the answer. For sure. And when you stop everything, stop trying, everything comes to you. And people should just stop trying to do stuff and just let it come to them, and they'll know. They just know.
Well, on that note, guys, I think I'm going to get out of here. We're getting a bad thunderstorm just rolling in right now. And I have two cats that are outside somewhere in all this stuff. So. Yeah, I'm going to go play cat rescue and see if I can't find my kitties. All right. Well, thanks for having me. And I have your link, Ceiling Fan Man, and Shapu. I'm about to put yours in the description as well. And any closing thoughts, Shapu?
Yes, people, have faith and let faith guide you. You don't need to try too hard to try to understand this life. Just do it, then everything will come easily, because this is how it is.
Love your neighbor. Treat others how you would like to be treated. These are simple things to live by, you know, and there's so many people out there, so many cultural different mindsets, so many people believing in all these supposed different gods. When we find out a lot of these gods seem to be the same god, and it's like they have us divided on all these levels. That's another thing too, you know. Mm-hmm. I've never even looked at anything with the Quran prior to the other day. And just the little few verses that I looked at were very compelling. And I'm really starting to think about things, you know, like what have they gotten us into as far as our consciousness, our mindset as a race of people together, dividing us on all these levels. It's really shameful. And it's sad that generation after generation have been born into this type of mindset, and we feel separated by that. You know, not only are we separated by countries and border lines and all this stuff like that, and it's religious beliefs and cultural beliefs and all this stuff like that. And I'm just grateful to be here with you guys. I don't really want to go off on too much of a tangent there, but yeah.
Well, I just want to say to everybody that's listening or that's here, just know that there's more to what's going on than just the discussions that you see on these screens, and look into it yourself. Don't take everything that comes off of these screens as the only way that you're going to think and do things. You need to look into, we always tell everyone, do your own research, and we're telling our own community, do your own research, and not just about how the sun and the moon and everything works, or even if a building's been melted. Find out the reason why. Why are mm-hmm. we here? What is our purpose? How did these events happen? There obviously was some massive event, because no matter what side you're on, everyone can agree that you can find evidence of floods or melts or whatever. It doesn't matter. So that is what God said, or like Jen was showing, there's lessons to be learned, and if we forget history, we repeat it, or we just get buried in it, is the way I see it now. So use this time, instead of saying, why is the community fighting, just don't worry about that and do your own research, watch the shows you want, but just know, if you're following people that are telling you there is no spiritual battle, God and Satan only exist in your head, if you're wrong, I don't think that's a good position to be in. Whereas if you're what we're saying has some merit to it, which I believe it does, all you've become is a better person, and you have a ticket out of here, and that's what I see it. And God love you all, and I'll do a show Friday, and God willing, and it's a pleasure. Shapu, your pictures, I don't know where you find them. Continue to do that. You're obviously a blessing to this channel. Thank you. And Jen, you know how much I adore you, so thank you for letting me be here.
I love you too. Thank you so much. All right, guys, let it not be said that we stood by and did nothing. If you don't stand for something, you'll fall for everything. And we are out of here. I love you guys.
Thank you all. Love you all.